Hitachi presents ESPN's Thanksgiving weekend of college football.
Dinner and dessert consumed. We welcome you to the North Shore of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where it's a chilly night. But old friends are getting together on the football field. That means one thing. No matter how cold it is, they're here for Pittsburgh, West Virginia. It's a football night in football country. This is Western Pennsylvania, where from the steel mills to the steel skyscrapers, football is Pittsburgh's passion. An emotion and affection shared 70 miles south, down the country roads taking West Virginians home. For a century, it's more than a road connecting West Virginia and Pittsburgh. It's an intense college football rivalry. A series that has seen great comebacks, seen big stars, and moments each school relishes forever. Their paths intersect this Thanksgiving, going in different directions. Pittsburgh is building on the drama of a record-passing performance at Notre Dame, leading to an emotional win. While West Virginia was relinquishing championship control with a loss at home. But tonight, a last shot to save a season of big dreams as the Maine Mountaineer plays his final regular season game in his hometown, knowing dreams of a BCS berth will only survive with a win tonight. Between the city and the country, a backyard for an annual football brawl. Field, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Thanksgiving night 2004, and college football primetime presented by Cooper Tires. Number 21 of the Lion, preseason pick of the Big East, West Virginia taking on the homestanding Pittsburgh Panthers. The game important for both teams for this reason. If West Virginia wins, they'll have no worse than a share of the Big East title. If Pittsburgh wins, they'll have a chance for a four-way tie. No matter who wins, they'll be rooting for Syracuse to beat Boston College as the top half of the league meets on the final weekend of the season. And we extend our late but certainly sincere happy Thanksgiving greetings. Mike Tirico, Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit. There's no better honor than being welcomed into someone's home on the holiday, and we thank you for having us into your homes here tonight. Well, guys, as we get ready for Thanksgiving, we're in Western Pennsylvania. As we said, great football country, and just think over the years, terrific quarterbacks in this area, and the quarterbacks are going to be huge in who wins tonight's battle.
Well, Mike, you know, Rasheed Marshall, West Virginia's quarterback, is the leading rusher in the history of the Big East for the quarterback position, and he has been absolutely sensational in his games against Pittsburgh. He's 2-0 against Pittsburgh, and West Virginia has scored 69 points in those two games, and he has personally accounted for 5 touchdowns. Now, this guy can run. He can beat you with the pass. Rasheed is a wonderful quarterback, and if Pittsburgh has any chance in the world to beat this football team, they got to somehow contain this quarterback. He's a sensational player.
Hey, his ability to run and throw really can cause you nightmares. You look at the Pittsburgh offense, that had to break in 10 new starters when they started this season. All of a sudden, 9 or 10 games into the season, they've started to create quite a bit of confidence, and it's because of Tyler Palko, their quarterback. Here's a quarterback that is on fire. 3 straight games of over 300 yards. Of course, the big game against Notre Dame where he had 5 touchdowns. In those 3 games, 11 touchdowns, only 1 interception. He's in rhythm. He's playing with a great deal of confidence. His teammates around him now believe that he is their guy. And tonight, you're going to see West Virginia defend the run. They're going to put everything up to stop the run. Tyler Palko could have a big night tonight for Pittsburgh.
Their offense doesn't have other stars. West Virginia is without one of its big stars on offense as we go in tonight. We'll detail that in a little bit. Oh, by the way, it is freezing cold. The wind chill is under 20. Pity Jill Arrington, who's on the sideline. We'll hear from her about the name of this rivalry in a bit. But first, happy Thanksgiving to Chris Fowler in the studio.
All right, Michael, same to you. Trev Albertson, Mark May alongside. We'll get the report later on just how much turkey Herbstreit ate. I was interested to find that out. Guys, momentum, morale, an important factor in this game. The rivalry marked that you were 4-0 in head-to-head against the Mountaineers, average score 40-10. We had to look that up. He didn't remember how dominant. But the emotions are the same years later, all these years later.
Yeah, but the thing about a game like this in Pittsburgh and Western Pennsylvania, a lot of these kids played high school football together. When I played in, a lot of my teammates played with the guys or against the guys in high school there at West Virginia. The key to this game, respect on the field. There was always respect between both teams on the field. A lot of hard hitting out there. But it was the fans that I didn't like at West Virginia. They threw fruit. They threw bad or you thought you always had to wear your helmet down there in Morgantown, but luckily for Pitt, the game's in Pittsburgh.
I bet the one thing you guys did do when you won is you stopped the run.
Yes.
And I think that's the whole story for this game right here. Mike Tirico hit on it at the start of the top there, and what it is, you know, West Virginia, look at this offense and Rashid Marshall at quarterback. They run the spread offense, but the bottom line is they want to run the football. And they run the football, they run the football, then they take a shot over the top with Chris Henry. Well, Chris Henry is suspended for this game. He's not there. That's why I think Pittsburgh's going to win this game. Paul Rhodes, a defensive coordinator, with no Chris Henry, you take eight or nine guys, you put them in the box, and you slow down. You will not stop West Virginia's rushing offense, but you slow them down, and I think Pittsburgh's got a great chance of doing that. That's why I think they win the game.
And filling in for Henry, a backup quarterback they've moved over. Plus, you don't know how that's going to affect the morale. They stumbled coming in. Pittsburgh has been surging coming in, so we'll see how things play out in the backyard brawl. We'll be back at halftime. Highlights of Peyton Manning's brilliant performance again. Plus, we'll look at the battle for Big East and ACC honors this weekend. But enjoy the first half coming up next.
ESPN's College Football Primetime. Brought to you by the Home Depot. You can do it. We can help. Bacardi Silver Limon Premium Malt Beverage. Flavor your night. And the new singular, Raising the Bar.
Not bad, guys, not bad. But it looks like last year's model. Have you got any that do more than just make phone calls? Send in the new guys!
Here you go, Pops. Video phone.
Video and picture messaging? This is brilliant. What's the little orange thing?
That's our logo.
Looks like the Singular logo to me.
What a coincidence.
This holiday season at Singular, get a great deal on a cool video phone. Capture, save, and send video. The new Singular. Raising the bar.
You know, I think I'd marry you again. All these people as witnesses?
Yeah, right. Mom? Dad?
Lisa, will you marry me? Again.
This Christmas, give her a piece of eternity.
Tonight's game from Pittsburgh, available on ESPN HD, thanks to our friends at Best Buy and Phillips. The backyard brawl for the 97th time, West Virginia and Pittsburgh. They know each other quite well. To tell us more about that, we say good evening to Jill Arrington.
Well, Mike, with a nickname like the backyard brawl, both of these coaches are hoping this rivalry doesn't live up to its name. In light of all the unsportsmanlike conduct in the NBA and in college football, both coaches have addressed this issue with their teams, saying, guys, you've got to keep your cool. You've got to keep your emotions in check, and most of all, you need to respect the game. After all, guys, it's Thanksgiving. Let's hope this rivalry is played out on the field. And guys, by the way, it's kind of cold out here. I hope you're enjoying that warm and toasty booth.
Jill, it is cold up here too. The wind is blowing in. If you factor in the west-northwest wind at 12 with a temperature of 29, our wind chill is under 20. That 30% chance of snow would be only light flurries. It looked like most of that stuff has dried up as it came off the lake from earlier this morning. Virginia won the toss, and they will receive the kickoff.
I say, that was a good look this morning. I thought we'd have some fun tonight.
Yeah, it did look nice. Snow.
Isn't this interesting? For the first time this year, I think a team has won the toss and decided to take the football. I think it's the first time this year.
First time we've had it, for sure. And Pac-Man Jones ready to receive for West Virginia. A very good return man. Has scored touchdowns four different ways in his West Virginia career. Adam Gressel will kick it off for Pittsburgh. Again, the winner is alive for a BCS berth. Boston College controls its own destiny at home Saturday against Syracuse. But the Eagles will be playing with a backup quarterback who's never started a game. So the winner tonight could make their way into a BCS game. Off we go on Thanksgiving night, and Pac-Man takes it from the five. Adam Jones returns across the 25 and out to the 28-yard line. Jameel Brady made the tackle. This is the final Big East game for Rashid Marshall, the West Virginia quarterback from Brashear High School, not too far from here. When Pittsburgh used to play its games on campus, he'd ride his bicycle to Pitt Stadium and sneak in. He's seen Pittsburgh football for a long time, grew up in this area, wasn't recruited as a quarterback, was recruited as a quarterback 70 miles down the road in West Virginia. He's only become the all-time Big East rushing leader as a quarterback, past Michael Vick and Donovan McNabb. Opening drive starts from the 28. And there goes the running threat. Marshall on the edge. Gain of 7 out of bounds at the 35. To introduce you to his teammates on the Bud Light starting lineups. The running back issue a little shaky because K.J. Harris, their senior, is banged up. Don't know how much of him we'll see tonight. Dwayne Thompson, McQuill Henderson, and Brandon Miles important. As Trev mentioned in the studio, Chris Henry suspended for this game. Ryan Thompson. Thomas is the tight end. Up front, Dan Moses out of Washington, Pennsylvania, here on the western side of the state. He's the best as Watson, the left tackle, and Brown, the center, play their final Big East games as well. Official gain of 7, 2nd and 3. On the hands of Jason Colson. Not much there. Into the middle of that defensive line for Pittsburgh. Defense that's improved. Not many superstars on this side of the ball. So let Krachunas and Stevens, those tackles up front, they're academic All-Americans and good players. Thomas Smith, the most talented up front. The linebackers, Malcolm Postel, Clint Session, and H.B. Blades, the son of the former NFL star, Benny Blades. In the secondary, the cornerbacks, Revis and Lay, have been pretty good. Tez Morris and Tyrone Gilliard are the safeties. Lay and Revis, the two corners, both from Aliquippa, Pennsylvania. Third down toss is a first down picked up across the 40 by Colson, and he takes it out to the 43-yard line. A pickup of 8 to the sophomore running back out of the backfield. For those not used to West Virginia's offense, give us a little feel for what they like to do.
We see it, it seems like, every week. A spread offense. Rasheed Marshall, because of the experience now with Rich Rodriguez's offense, a lot of times a no huddle, looks over a lot to Rich to get the signal, and has a great command of this offense and the ability to run and throw.
Caught behind the line is Colson there. A loss of 2 on the play as Clint Session, the middle linebacker out of Florida, came in to make the play. Talk about Rich Rodriguez, their head coach, a West Virginia alum. Big East Coach of the Year last year. His team has disappointed him, I think, a little bit here in how they've closed this season.
His background was with Tommy Bowden at Tulane and Clemson. That's where they developed this kind of a spread offense that focuses on the run.
2nd and 12. The bench is telling him it's going to go to the right. The pass comes back to the near side, and McQuill Henderson wrapped up at the 45-yard line. So Pittsburgh's defense very aware of what West Virginia likes to do here. Lay on that tackle.
Thing to keep in mind tonight with Marshall is Pittsburgh and their defensive coordinator, Paul Rhodes, it's a little bit of a cat and mouse game. Because of the ability of Marshall to run and throw, how many times do we see defenses try to outnumber the opponent up in tight to the line of scrimmage, up at the box? Well, in this case, it's tough to do that because of Marshall's ability. You can't account for him. So it makes it very tough to defend the run of Marshall and then also the pass of those great receivers that they have.
4 wide receivers, 3rd and 8. They run out of it, up the middle with Colson. He's stopped at midfield, 2.5 yards shy of the first down. And on 4th down, let's see what the Mountaineers will do. Rasheed Marshall has punted in quick kick form a couple of times. Marshall stays on the field here, moves to a wide receiver spot. Doesn't necessarily mean they're going to go for it. Out of the bag of tricks. Phil Brady, the kicker, doesn't get a great one off. And it will go out of bounds at the 21. A punt of just 29 yards. So Rich Rodriguez's team only picks up a first down. And now Pittsburgh will come out with Tyler Palko, the quarterback. This is one of those guys who was born and bred to be a quarterback. When he was an infant, he had a little onesie for as a baby that said football player on it. Before he was 10 years old, he was drawing up plays on the chalkboard. His dad was a coach. He traveled wherever dad went, soaking up game film. He has been around here a couple of years. One of those guys you got to kick out of the office. He comes off a record-setting 5-touchdown performance. Raymond Kirkley. His back gets about 10 right at the first down marker as Adam Jones pushed him out of bounds. On the Bud Light starting lineups, Kirkley, a junior out of Madison, Virginia, not too far from Charlottesville. Tim Murphy's healthy. That improves this team. Greg Lee averages 20 a catch. Del Sardo's a walk-on who's earned a scholarship Gill, the tight end, averages 13 a catch. They spread it well. Up front, Rob Pettine is a senior. First team All-Big East the last couple of years. Spencer came over from the defensive side and has helped that improved offensive line. It was a first down and a gain of 10 for Kirkley. And a little entree into the neutral zone by West Virginia. Tom Tomczyk is the referee here tonight.
Offside, 92, defense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
That is Ben Lynch, who is celebrating a birthday today. The nose tackle's 23 years old. Walt Harris, the head coach of the Panthers, trying to take him to a bowl for the fifth consecutive year. And we'll develop the story as we go on. There's been a lot of conversation if Walt will be back here at Pittsburgh next year. He's a very, very good offensive mind, has been around some very good players, college and pro. Greg Lee, the flanker. A yard shy of the first down. Anthony Mims, the quarterback on the field side, the wide side of the field, made the tackle. This defense is a 3-3-5. Kirk and Lee will tell you what it does, what confusion it causes. Lynch in the middle, a senior out of Oil City, Pennsylvania, same high school as the middle linebacker, Adam Lenort, who's joined by Scott Jerko and Jeff Nochel. The two guys on the edge, walk-ons who become starters. And the five across, Adam Jones, he's a quarterback, but he's their top tackler with Lorello and across to Adai, Adina, and Mims, who just made the last tackle. As they measure here, why don't you guys tell us about the 3-3-5?
The 3-3-5, we saw a version of it last week with Utah and BYU. This is a little bit different. It was interesting talking to Walt Harris. See if they've close call here.
Might have to go for the card, see if you can get any room in there.
That's tight.
Oftentimes, the official will take a card out of his pocket, see if you can slide it between the nose of the ball and the top, and just a chain link shot.
Well, the 3-3-5, essentially, Walt Harris said, you mean the 3-5-3? Well, he said, well, no, it's the 3-3-5. He said, well, no, what I'm saying, I call it 3-5-3 because those two hybrid safety linebacker guys that are in the back basically are up at the line of scrimmage, so it's an eight-man front, and they blitz those linebackers from so many different areas, and they're so physical with their three-down linemen that it makes it really tough to run the football.
What it makes it difficult for a team like Pittsburgh is they've only seen it like this is the first time all year.
Right.
So they don't have a chance to practice against it and know exactly what goes on. Also, remember, this is the new defense because it's good against spread offenses.
As you saw, they truly were an inch short of the first down. So a run on second, and Kirkley pounds it in there. He'll take the first down out to the 45. Nice look from Skycam as you look at the pile on this field that is absolutely just beaten up. Guys, the Under Armour advantage here tonight.
For West Virginia, Rasheed Marshall, 2-0 against Pittsburgh. His offense has scored 69 points in two games. And as Kirk and Mike mentioned, an unconventional defense, 3-3-5. They blitz from all areas. It's the first time Pittsburgh has seen this defense.
Yeah, it's almost like as a defense seeing the triple option from the old Air Force offense. Pittsburgh team unity. This team believes in themselves. They got a lot of momentum, of course, coming off of the big game against Notre Dame, winning in South Bend.
Palco, first deep ball of the night. Not there. He can take off. An effective runner. Not Rasheed Marshall effective, but he'll do enough to be something to keep an eye on defensively for Adam Lenort and the rest of the Mountaineers. Gain of five there.
This is what I think is interesting about Tyler Palco. He's a, Mike, you mentioned, he's a coach's son. Not only has he played quarterback, but he also has a defensive mentality playing safety in high school. He loves to scramble, but one of the things that he does well for a young guy is he doesn't lose his vision downfield. He's looking to scramble to buy time to get the ball thrown downfield, but if you leave room like they did there, he'll pick up some valuable yardage.
From midfield, with the fullback Campbell leading the way, Kirkley couldn't get to the second level because of the play by Ben Lynch. Lynch, the top tackler on the defensive line. He's added 20 pounds, was a linebacker, has grown into a senior and a force on the nose for the Mountaineers.
When we talked to the offensive line coach, Tom Friedman from West Virginia, from Pittsburgh, he said that he thought Ben Lynch was the dominant player on their entire defensive football team. The best football player is right there in the middle, Ben Lynch, number 92.
Third wide receiver in the game, Derek Kinder. Need to get past the 45 to keep the drive alive. Palco is pressured, eludes the would-be sack by Jerko, and it's incomplete. One thing you have to learn with Tyler Palko, every play stays alive. He has a unique knack of getting out of sacks and trouble. Couldn't complete that one. And Pittsburgh will kick it away for the first time tonight with Adam Gressel. And the Pac-Man, Adam Jones, back deep to receive. And strong average leads the Big East, top 10 in the country. If you've watched games that the Pittsburgh Steelers have played here, you know the wind can play huge tricks. It swirls in from the left of your screen to the right, down at the south open end of Heinz Field. Flag down, back at the kicker. Was he roughed or run into?
Won't matter, really.
Yeah,
first down.
Close.
So close.
Might have to measure it here.
One thing about this, though, the kicker, when he kicked it, he moved over into the West Virginia player's path. I hope we get a chance to see that, because that was not what I think a good call.
Running into the kicker, number 43, defense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
They say first down right away. Yep, it is, by a quarter of a yard. The penalty here on Kevin McLean.
Now, Crystal, now just watch the way he goes. See where he is? He's leaning over. He was actually his left foot right now. Watch it. See how far he is to the right, Mike? I'm not so sure that was a real good call, Kirk, because he looked like he leaned right into the way the defensive man was coming.
Pretty good acting, I think.
I think I agree.
He's smiling. Happy Thanksgiving.
He's happier than himself.
That was not a good call.
I do think he was trying to kick towards that right side away from Pac-Man, but he left the layout there for the Rockette kick a bit long. Kirkley dances in the hole and gets, let's give him 2.5 yards or so. On the first down carry by the junior, who's a very hard runner, as Lawrence Adina came in for the hit.
This Pittsburgh team fell off the radar a bit this year with losing Larry Fitzgerald and Rod Rutherford and so many great players. In fact, their first game, they broke in 10 new starters on offense. I think a lot of people expected them to fade away and not be a factor, not only in the Big East, but, of course, in the BCS and the national picture. And they're second in their conference now in scoring offense.
Palko, quick toss, incomplete. We'll have third and eight coming up.
Big reason for that has been the development of Tyler Palko. This team, as a group, they've really grown up. But I think it was the Notre Dame game a couple weeks ago in South Bend where Tyler Palko had the game of his life. He had 5 touchdown passes against the Irish, something that has never happened in South Bend. And I think at this point is when the team, he took the team over. He willed his team to a victory. And my favorite was his teammate said the final drive, he said, "You're going to remember this drive for the rest of your lives." And then he let them down to a game, eventually a game-winning field goal.
A third and eight pass intended to Tim Murphy, his fullback slash halfback, is incomplete. Off his hands, and we'll get back to another punt, unable to capitalize on the penalty.
And remember, this is a young Pitt team. They've only got 5 seniors, 2 on offense and 3 on defense. So they've got a good future. You'd put Palko with these young guys, nice looking football team in the future here for Pittsburgh.
So once again, Adam Gressel, the sophomore out of Dublin, Ohio, back to kick. And the young man out of the Columbus suburb hangs it high. Adam Jones lets it go. It goes into the end zone. A touchback. 3 first downs for Pittsburgh, 1 for West Virginia so far. No score as Rasheed Marshall, who had to get 40 tickets for all his friends and family from Pittsburgh, he gets set to take the field.
In the boys. Looks like you fellas are having some kind of party.
No, sir.
See, we've had reports of referees taking people's Bud Light and replacing it with Miller Lite.
Oh, that's awful. So wrong. Man, that's absolutely.
Yeah, it's bad. Listen, guys, I'm going to need to see a receipt for that Bud Light.
Jerry, you got that receipt?
Yeah, receipt. Yeah, I got it right.
Run!
Some people will do anything to get the great taste of Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here.
We got zebras on the run requesting backup.
His name's Cole. He was 13 days late. And there was literally a point where I thought I was, you know, going to be pregnant forever. Where you spend your whole life putting yourself first, and then just like that, you're second. And you're just so thankful. That's why I bought a Saturn.
The 5-star crash safety rated 2005 Saturn View. Now with 5 years, 60,000 mile extended vehicle coverage or a $1,250 allowance.
It's not your job.
It's not your accent.
Not your clothes.
It's not your car.
It's not your lipstick.
It's not your friends.
It's not your shoes.
It's not your laugh.
It's not your hair.
It's your watch.
You can tell more about a person by the watch they wear than anything else. Seiko Kinetic, powered by the movement of your body.
Available at Macy's.
There's a whole new way to look at fajitas.
Ooh, fajitas.
The Fajita Grill Stuffed Burrito from Taco Bell. Loaded with authentic carne asada steak and grilled fajita vegetables. All wrapped in a flour tortilla and grilled to go.
Ooh, fajitas.
For sizzling fajita taste, think outside the bun.
This game is the most important on the schedule. Not Notre Dame, not Nebraska, not Boston College. It's West Virginia.
It's the final game. You know, I'm finishing up in my hometown, and, you know, it's the backyard brawl.
I don't really like them too much, and I'm sure they don't like me.
Whatever I have to do to get my team going and whatever we have to do to win the game, you know, we're ready to do it.
The players have been a part of this before. Now center stage in this 97th. West Virginia-Pittsburgh matchup, and Rasheed Marshall wearing the Mountaineer colors back in his hometown. Drive start from the 20, and a nice soft throw to Heike Johnson. Took it out to the 35. The ball came out, but he was down already. Malcolm Postel made the tackle, but a 15-yard gain. We mentioned Marshall from here. His home was Webster Avenue. Brashear High School was where he was a star. Very good football, as many of you know, in this Western Pennsylvania area. But as so often is the case, athletic quarterbacks, many schools come in, and the first impression is, and we'd love to move you to wide receiver. We'd love to move you to safety, maybe to cornerback. Rasheed was really excited about the opportunity to play at West Virginia, and the arrival of Rich Rodriguez in this spread offense 4 years ago has worked out well. Jason Colson, quick toss on the edge, a nice first down run, and we'll give him about 8 yards there.
You know what, Mike? He reminds me of Antoine Randall-El, who plays here for the Pittsburgh Steelers. When he was at Indiana, he was a great return man. He was a great receiver, catching, running, throwing. Randall-El and Marshall are the same kind of athletes, Kirk. And I tell you what, the next level, he might have a hard time playing quarterback.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, I think he can play in the pros somewhere like Randall-El.
I think his acceleration has improved so much. He's probably the fastest guy on this West Virginia football team. You're probably right. That's his best chance at the next level.
And there you see. He's a second back in the backfield. He's now in the secondary. Took it to the 38. Pickup of 19 yards. And you can hear the Mountaineer fans. They're here to cheer their team here tonight.
This is Herb Street's favorite play, the old option play, read option. Now watch, number two, Rasheed Marshall will read the outside end. As the end goes inside, not that hits his key to run, but right there, poo! Look at this, Kirk.
And watch how he gets upfield. This is the difference right here, right there. That's the difference in Rasheed Marshall from the last couple years to this year.
From the 38, he hands to Colson. Jason takes it out to the 32. Tyrone Gilliard in on the tackle. We mentioned as a Big East performer, Michael Vick only there for 2 years, but then Donovan McNabb there for four. Both were surpassed for Big East total rushing yards by a quarterback, so obviously he's the Mountaineer leader in that category. And as you see, the other significant offensive categories, he has put up some of the best numbers at WVU ahead of Major Harris, who went to the same high school as Rasheed. His pass there is incomplete. Never got his feet set. Clint Session was ready to hit him. And Jillick has more on Marshall.
Well, Mike, you mentioned it earlier, quarterback Rasheed Marshall. He grew up in the shadows of Pitt Stadium. And like you said, he used to have to sneak into those games. But, you know, this one's a little bit different. He said he has 40 friends, family, that wanted to come see his homecoming. He says, I got a little something special for him. I want to win this game so that I can come back home later with bragging rights and a little bit of pride. So look to see him with some amazing moves on the field, which we know he's capable of.
Yeah, Joe, when we spoke to him this week, he was so excited about the opportunity to play his last Big East game here at home. His throw is caught. The grab inside the 10 and brought down to the 7-yard line. So on third down, a pickup of 25 for Eddie Jackson, the senior who has only caught 14 balls all year and has been bothered by a knee injury.
Well, with Chris Henry down, some of these other receivers are going to have to step up. And in this case, Eddie Jackson makes a catch here, but it was the patience by Marshall that opened this up, and he split the linebacker and the safety, and he put it right into a very tight window, showed his ability to throw the football. He's not just a guy back there running around. He can throw it.
First and goal for the Mountaineers. Here is Colton. Hit his own line, but bounced outside and takes it to the end zone. Touchdown, West Virginia. A beautiful 80-yard drive in only a couple of minutes. For Colson, his sixth touchdown of the season. And Brad Cooper will come on to attempt the extra point. He keeps a perfect extra point season going. Seven plays and 80 yards inside of 2 minutes. It only took a minute 44. Colson capped it off. The running and passing of Marshall gets him there. And the sophomore from Rochester, New York, takes it home.
We've got the whole league covered on the hardest working pregame show in football. Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by Old Spice, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
You've got some viewing to do.
I don't know what I was thinking.
I tried to tell you, genius.
I can't believe I'm in this situation. We're not having fun anymore.
I'm feeling your pain.
I don't know what to do.
Hey, look at me. We all make mistakes.
Told you about the tires, huh?
Yeah. You should have gotten Cooper.
Buying tires is a big decision. Next time, get everything you want. Cooper Tires. Don't give up a thing.
As any military man worth his salt will tell you, the choice of artillery will vary from operation to operation. Consider a daylight maneuver with a strong civilian presence. Here you'll find the manual calls for a lighter ordnance. Mission accomplished. Sometimes the light way is the right way to live the high life.
I mean, I used to date these guys, and I'd wonder, why doesn't this feel right? You know, why isn't he the one? And then I met Ben. It's really nice when you realize you don't have to compromise. I mean, not to compare my man to a car, but I mean, that's why I bought a Saturn.
The 2005 Saturn Ion. Redesigned, uncompromised. Now with 5 years, 60,000 mile extended vehicle coverage or a $1,000 allowance.
Glad you are joining us here on Thanksgiving weekend, presented by Hitachi. The winner of this game, the 97th meeting between these two teams, controls some of its hopes for the BCS, because Boston College is the team only in control of its own destiny, but the winner is still alive for a BCS berth. Colson brought it in. The Mountaineers, so good, jumping on teams, but teams candidly that weren't very good. They have beaten a bunch of average to below average teams this year. They lost their two games against the best teams they played, Virginia Tech and Boston College. Kind of done what you need to do to have a good season. Line drive kickoff. It is Furman with the return. And Marcus keeps it alive across the 20, but he's pulled down at the 21. Well followed on special teams. Let's take you back to the touchdown.
Let's take a look at 69 Garen Justice right there. 6'8", 325 pounds. Watch when he gets a hold of the defensive man. Now, Kirk, watch him keep his feet. Keep his feet. That's good. But now comes the real play right there.
I love watching Colson run here, and I think for young running backs who are watching this tonight, this is a great example of why your coaches tell you, don't give up on a play. Keep moving your feet. You never know where you might end up, and in that Colson's case, he found the end zone.
So after West Virginia scores, Palko and the Panthers need to try to answer. Tim Murphy sticks it inside, gets it to the 24-yard line, a gain of three.
96.
Tyler Palco was highly recruited. This is his first year as a starter. Would have come in and pushed Rod Rutherford, who was a very good four-year quarterback for Pittsburgh, in his freshman year. However, Palco injured his hand during his freshman year. Nobody knew how it happened. Injured the hand. It slowed him down that year. Then the red shirt. Now this season, as an athletic sophomore, 11 touchdowns and one interception as he's come on the last few games. The running game has helped when he can throw it well, too. Murphy out to the 35-yard line. You see those numbers that we just showed you on the quarterback, Palco, 11 touchdowns and one interception. Five of them coming, as Kirk showed you, against Notre Dame. And what an emotional comeback it was for Pittsburgh as they rallied in that game to win 41-38. Built a big lead in the first half. Notre Dame rallied. Pittsburgh comes back. Win it on a field goal with 1 second left. And you may have seen the game as a very emotional Pittsburgh team led by Palco, who had an unfortunate incident right after the game on the field, carried by Murphy for a couple. Palco said one of the words the FCC says you can't say on live TV. He was very embarrassed about it and talked about it earlier this week.
It was one of those things where I got caught up in the moment. You know, our football team has gone through so much, and, you know, we just won a big football game. And, I mean, I was, it was just one of those things that slipped out.
He felt bad. He was embarrassed that he brought embarrassment to his school, which he loves so much. And it was just a case of a young kid caught up in the moment, made a mistake. Second down toss for Palco to Kelly Campbell, his fullback, out to the 41-yard line, a gain of five. Let's go back to the studio and Chris.
All right, Mike, Taco Bell takes us to Ford Field, where Peyton Manning and the Colts just carved up your Lions like a Thanksgiving turkey. Brandon Stokely catches this one. Six TD passes for Manning today, 41 for the season, seven short of the all-time season record held by the ex-Panther, Dan Marino. Back to you guys.
Manning, nothing short of brilliant.
Oh, he threw six, and he probably could have thrown 10.
Easily.
Yeah,
easily. Pressured by Jerko. Flag is down. Palco's down. Adam Lenort finally caught up with him. Twice Scott Jerko's had him locked on a radar. He's gotten away, but I think there's going to be a holding penalty on the Panthers here. I'll decline that. Pittsburgh's going to have to kick it away.
Jerko, number 33, runs right over Marcus Furman, number two. Boom! Why? Furman is 5'9", 185, and he just ran right over him, Kirkle did. Kirk, I like the way this West Virginia defense is kind of reacting, keeping everything in front of them and then reacting. You notice how quick they reacted to the ball?
Yep.
And looking good.
They also, we talked about their 3-3-5, how it's built around pressure and confusion, and right now they are confusing Pittsburgh's offensive line and winning the battle in the trenches.
Walk him off the corner coming after Gressel. That was not a good snap, and he hit his personal protector. It's free in the air. The Mountaineers will have it inside the 16. The ball wasn't directly blocked, but the ball ended up being kicked into the back of J.J. Horn, the personal protector. Guys, they snapped the ball very slow. Their slow snap back to center is the reason this got blocked, and they've had special team issues.
And sometimes he knows which way that snap is going, Mike. It's going into the wind.
Yeah.
And I remember Jackie Sherrill telling us anytime... To bring
stop
it up, whole story.
Out.
And you get the stopwatch. Anytime you're going against the wind like that with a snap, go for the kick. See, it's way over there.
That's the second one that's been way off to the right there. Whether that's the, I don't think that's the wind taking it to the right. I think he's just,
it's right.
He's just missing to the right.
They've had four punts blocked this year. They've been special teams poor. West Virginia was special teams awful.
Yeah, I was going to say against Boston College, that cost them a game.
Huge opportunity here. Let Marshall and the Mountaineers take over in the red zone. They hand it to K.J. Harris, who tried to pick up a block from his quarterback and ended up losing about 3 yards. Dan Stevens, on the nose, made the play. Dan Stevens, one of those stories of people who you root for. An All-American academically, a 3.76 grade point average, but also a young man who has to wake up at 3 in the morning to give himself an insulin shot in the abdomen, suffering from diabetes since age 10. He's now become a mentor to young kids with diabetes, letting them know that you can be as much of an athlete as you want. A great example he is. Marshall pressured and brought down on the nose by his running mate on the nose, the other academic All-American, Vince Korchunas.
And Steven and Korchunas is coming up the middle. Now, one thing about Stevens and Korchunas, one, Stevens has 38 starts, Korchunas has 35 starts. Those guys have been around here, Kirk, a long time.
Yep. Tough as they get inside
here. Yeah, tough. Yep. West Pennsylvania tough guys.
Third and 17. Marshall down the middle. Caught by Harris, the running back, just a couple of yards shy of the first down. And that bad field may have cost him a first down. Fourth and a couple here.
The way his defense is playing, it wouldn't be surprising to see him go for it here. Yep. He'd take the points.
Well, he's in a pro stadium. The National Football League style is to take the points every single time you get down there. I know sometimes we don't agree.
Right, right. But speaking of pro stadium, and this beautiful, I know it's cold, but I'm just saying this is a nice, one of the nicest facilities in the country.
Brad Cooper from 26 yards. He's been perfect inside of 30 this season. And the senior from Bowling Green, Kentucky, knocks it through. So without their top receiver, West Virginia has a nice drive and a pretty good opportunity taken over in the red zone to capitalize on the block punt to go up 10.
ESPN Original Entertainment presents
NASCAR's gotta have talent. You're magic on the asphalt.
Barry Pepper stars as Dale Earnhardt 3. Premieres Saturday, December 11th, 9 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. Looking for a big league gift for your future pro? The new ESPN Game Station by Fisher-Price. It's 6 sports in one. Basketball, football, baseball, soccer, hockey, golf. The ESPN Game Station in stores now.
I've been playing for years. But this year, I made my first hole-in-one.
I think growing older is a gift. This year I became proud of my laugh lines.
The Rolex Datejust. The year it takes to make one is nothing compared to the time it takes to deserve one.
Online has always been faster than dial-up and DSL, but now there's only one clear winner because we've upgraded our network, making what was already the fastest high-speed internet access for the home even 40% faster than we were just 2 years ago. More than 150 times faster than dial-up, more than triple the speed of DSL. That's why 3 out of 4 people in our area who choose high-speed internet access choose Optimum Online. Introducing the new Optimum Online. The best just got better.
ESPN's College Football Primetime is presented by Cooper Tires. Confidence, performance, mileage, don't give up a thing. And in part by Saturn, people first.
The old leather helmet, they're tough here, as you said.
Look.
Western Pennsylvania.
They're in a popcorn.
Speaking of that, did you see Bill Frelick, the guy that does the
radio
for them?
Yes,
his number up there is 79. He's retired. What a great-looking football player he is. Mm-hmm.
Kickoff bounces back to Marcus Furman. He gets brought down to 27, so West Virginia's trying to clean up its special team problems and has forced Pittsburgh into long fields as we have some pushing going on until the end of the whistle. Eric Weeks comes up with the tackle. Well, let's remind you, as the weekend continues, our primetime game Saturday night from Reno, as Thanksgiving weekend presented by Hitachi brings you number 10, Boise State, trying to cap off a perfect season against Nevada. The game also available on ESPN HD. College Football Saturday presented by Crestor, 7:45 Eastern. There is Bill Frelick.
Hey,
yep, right by our colleague Mark May and our colleague Mike Ditka. Hugh Green, of course, on the far right. First down run by Tim Murphy. He brings it out to the 35. Nice 6-yard gain on first down. We talked about Boise State. You'll get a chance to see one of the 5 remaining unbeatens on Saturday night. Guys, we are five games away from five unbeatens. Notre Dame, US, and UCLA on the USC schedule. Oklahoma will play either Iowa State or Colorado in the Big 12 championship. Auburn plays Tennessee in the SEC title game. And we saw Utah cap off the perfect season in Salt Lake last week.
So much for Fowler's calculations. You're going to have five unbeatens at the end of the year.
Second and four. Falco's throw is incomplete. And we'll have third down coming up. Greg Lee
that wasn't
on
nice
the tackle.
That wasn't nice.
I know it wasn't nice, huh?
He brought it up.
I'm just saying.
I know, but he loves that calculation.
Chris has been calculating on ESPN.com and on game day on a regular basis here as we've gotten to the back end of the season, the statistical probability, and it was pretty high that you wouldn't have multiple teams
That's
finishing
right.
undefeated.
Yeah.
Still might happen.
Still? You got five there, Mike.
Five games away from five unbeaten as well. Third and four. Out goes pass complete to Greg Lee. The sophomore flanker catch 46 on the season and a very important first down pickup.
Not only an important first down pickup, but it very important for Tyler Palco to get him going a little bit and to get his receivers going, not only to pick up this first down, but finally to hit a pass downfield and to be able to maybe create a little bit of confidence that they can get off the press coverage and get open. But that's sometimes a little play like that can,
right.
It's a lot of times springboard this offense.
That Greg Lee leads the Big East with 103 yards receiving per game. He's a nice receiver.
What a shot. Pittsburgh is the top receiver in the Big East. Good play action for Palco, looking downfield and deep for Lee. Pulls it in. Inside the 20, Anthony Mims had the primary coverage. A gain of 37.
The interesting thing about this, remember when Walt Harris said he went down to Tampa, Florida to look at another football player, and he saw this guy, Greg Lee, and he said, yo, sweetheart, this guy's a pretty good football player, and he went to watch him play basketball, and he didn't even touch the ground when he ran. Wasn't that a great story?
A great story, and how about him turning Anthony Mims completely around with a little stem move to the outside to get open downfield. He also did a nice job of catching that football with his hands, taking it away from Pac-Man Jones.
First red zone snap. Palco takes off, gets a couple of yards. That should bring us to the end of the first quarter. Ben Lynch, second time he's come up with a big play here in the first 50. Well, Pittsburgh driving, important to get points. West Virginia scored on back-to-back possessions on this frigid night in Western Pennsylvania. Through 15, 10-0 for the Mountaineers, trying to claim a share of the Big East title with a win tonight.
Get the ESPN Full Court College Basketball pay-per-view package. Order now.
His name's Cole. He was 13 days late. And there was literally a point where I thought I was, you know, going to be pregnant forever. Where you spend your whole life putting yourself first, and then just like that, you're second. And you're just so thankful. That's why I bought a Saturn.
The five-star crash safety rated 2005 Saturn View. Now with 5 years, 60,000 mile extended vehicle coverage or a $1,250 allowance.
This holiday season, give that special someone on your list something they can't wait to use. Grab all your gifts and a tree to put them under. You can at the Home Depot. Starting this Friday, this straight line laser level is half off at just $9.96. And this Ryobi 7.2 volt cordless drill is an incredible $9.97. Nobody has more know-how to help make your holiday dollars work harder. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
At Fred Meyer Jewelers and Lipman Jewelers, these dazzling 1-carat total weight diamond earrings are on sale for $9.99. But for 3 days only, save an additional $400 and pay only $5.99 at Fred Meyer Jewelers and Lipman Jewelers.
Come on over, baby. Whole lot of steak is going on. Woo! We faking. Steak Stampede is going on.
Applebee's Steak Stampede.
Steak, baby, steak. Eating good in the name.
Thank you.
The Sharp Aquas Liquid Crystal Television. Enhanced sound is the answer.
This is titanium. Strong, long-lasting, durable. And only Remington brings it to you in the all-new titanium shaving system. Designed for closeness, comfort, and to clean itself automatically. Any way you slice it, it's extraordinary. Shave after shave. Remington Titanium. It could just make all other shavers obsolete. And for her, the Remington Smooth and Silky, America's number one women's brand.
Hope you're enjoying dessert, or for some of you, second trip through, reading the refrigerator for more Thanksgiving dinner. 10-0 the Mountaineers lead. They had one nice 80-yard drive and then capitalized on a special teams mistake for a field goal. Pittsburgh gets best drive of the night going. We start the quarter 2nd and 9. Pressure coming. Alco steps up and is brought down on a terrific effort by Kevin McLean. His birthday was yesterday. Probably the best athlete of that linebacking corps.
You know, we talked about the 3-3-5 and how confusing it can be. Look at how they run these linebackers in different angles. This is all to try to confuse Pittsburgh's offensive line. They do a good job here. The offensive line made the adjustment, but the speed of that blitz caused Palco to panic and step up in the pocket. Nice job by West Virginia.
3rd and 11. Kinder, the third wide receiver, will be to Palco's left. Just the play as the clock runs down. Throwing incomplete, intended for his tight end, Eric Gill. So the Panthers will probably try a field goal of about 37 yards.
Now, as good as Tyler Palco has played in the last three or four games, he's still a young guy. And to face this kind of defense really takes a lot of patience. That time they showed a lot of that same look from the play before, and then they dropped back into coverage and had five guys underneath. And I think that right now they're doing a very good job of forcing Tyler Palco to be unsettled back in the pocket.
37-yard attempt here, Kirk, for Josh Cummings out of Southern California. Long blonde hair. He is full out SoCal, and he is cold tonight. See how he kicks it in this weather. From 37, he turns it through. Nice job by Gressel, the punter, on the hole. Wasn't the best snap in the history of the game.
Is it SoCal?
Five-star relaxed fit premium quality denim. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
This is our house. Everything you have trained for your entire life has prepared you for this moment.
It's us versus them.
Power. All I want to talk about is how big they are. And that this is the year they knock us off. Well, when they come in here, they got to play our game in our house. Nobody beats us in our house. Yeah.
Say your husband went a little overboard buying the Christmas tree this year. Well, at Tractor Supply Company, we can help. There you have it, the perfect amount of holiday spirit.
Because the tricky thing about perfect right angles is the perfect part, Black & Decker created the Crossfire. It shoots horizontal and vertical lines that level automatically, so you get it right the first time. The Crossfire from Black & Decker.
So you're a guy who wants to get the girl, but you've got oily skin. So you get Nivea for Men Oil Control to get rid of oil and the shine and get the confidence you need to get the girl. Got it? Good. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
This is Rasheed Marshall, quarterback for West Virginia University. I would like to say happy Thanksgiving to all my friends and family, and have a happy holiday.
Happy Thanksgiving to all my family. I know most of you guys will be at the game. Don't eat too much. Save me some stuff for after the game.
Well, we extend our Thanksgiving wishes as well to all the family members who are watching who couldn't be here for this 97th meeting. It goes back to 1895. What a game they played here a couple of years ago. Record attendance here at Heinz Field, and that one, the stadium that opened in 2001. Last year in Morgantown, the Mountaineers won 52-31, and they ran for 307 yards. This kick's going out of bounds, and smartly they let it go out of bounds, and West Virginia will get a drive started at its own 35. This is another special teams clinic in a Big East game. Rasheed Marshall, 90 total yards, a lot of them on the last drive. The running ability getting them down close where they were able to score on the first drive, I should say, where they scored. And this special teams miscue, Gressel kicking it into his personal protector because of a bad snap, led to the field goal that made it 10-0. Pittsburgh just capped off a nice drive to put up its first points of the night. West Virginia will take over. Bud Palmer, sophomore, former defensive lineman's in there as a fullback now to lead Pernell Williams, freshman out of New Lebanon, Ohio. One of three backs West Virginia will use tonight. Williams, only a couple of yards there. This is the second Big East game of the day. Chris Fowler updates us on the first one.
All right, Mike, Taco Bell takes us to State University of New Jersey, where the UConn Huskies outscored the Scarlet Knights. Dan Orlovsky, three TD passes, two of them to Dan Murray. Cornell Brockington ran for three. Huskies expect a bowl bid, perhaps the Continental Tire versus the Tar Heels at 7-4.
Hey, Chris, that's what they're talking about. The catch here for John Pennington. And he's pushed out of bounds very close to the first down. It's going to be a yard short. J.J. Horn with the play. Congratulations to Randy Edsel at Connecticut, a program that has made the move from 1AA in 3 years to 7-4, 3-3. And I think Chris is right on. They'll probably end up in the Tire Bowl down in Charlotte, Continental Tire Bowl, taking on North Carolina.
And every time I think about how well they're doing, I think of Skip Holtz giving that job up to go down to South Carolina with his dad. Ooh. Ooh.
Third and one here for Marshall. He bounces it outside, but he's stopped by the Panther defense. Obviously, they know he's a good runner. The time they reacted well, and it will force a punt. Thomas Smith started it, Clint Session and Sam Bryant finished up.
I'm sure this is a good play call, but I don't like it. Maybe I'm an old timer, but if you're gonna have a foot and a half or 2 feet to go, you snap the ball 6 yards deep. Now you tell me, Kirk, the strategy behind that.
The strategy is to get the ball in the hands of your best player, and he's done it all year, and you think you can come up with a yard, but you have a true freshman leading the way in Pernell Williams, and that time he got Olay'd by the linebacker.
Phil Brady to punt it for West Virginia. Twin safeties back there. Alan Richardson takes it. This has been just an awful punt return team. There's nothing more you can say. Pittsburgh averages 5 yards a punt return.
Ooh,
they have three on that one.
That's just what the doctor ordered for West Virginia after that BC game.
4 yards a punt return. You're right.
Tiger Woods, Annika Sorenstam, Fred Couples, Adam Scott, an ABC Sports Thanksgiving weekend tradition. The Maryland Skins game, Saturday and Sunday on ABC.
Every motion picture begins with a single dramatic frame. Introducing the Hitachi UltraVision Cineform Series Plasma High Definition Television. Exclusive plasma technologies deliver the smoothest film-like picture. Original technologies, seamless integration. Only from Hitachi.
Save one for me.
The moonlight in your eyes.
Okay, we've got illegal use of the brain on Tom, passing out beer with less taste than Miller Lite. Replacing with great tasting, less filling Miller Lite. half the carbs of Bud Light. We've also got intentional acoustic romanticism on Gary. Girls not buying it, tent invitation declined.
Wait, what?
Play beer.
Chick State music.
Miller, good call.
Bass Pro Shops. It's more than a store. It's the place where outdoor adventures begin. It's dreaming of a white Christmas. It's looking back on good times and planning for new ones. It's fishing for ideas and hunting for just the right gift. It's finding something special at the lowest price guaranteed. And you can pick up Bass Pro Shops gift cards and share the adventure. Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here.
Our Thanksgiving weekend presented by Hitachi. 10-3 West Virginia. Pittsburgh getting the ball back here at Heinz Field. You know, the Rooney family, the owners of the Steelers, just great people. And the Rooneys truly made the Panthers feel like a co-tenant here in beautiful Heinz Field. The Panther name is on the outside of this place just as much as the Steelers. It was just a wonderful job done here in town by the Rooneys, as usual. The carry by Tim Murphy for about 5 yards. And we were over at the facility.
Practice facility.
Yeah, which they share with the Steelers as well, guys.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
In the meeting room, you look outside, and there's Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers leading the NFL with one of the best records in the game out there practicing on a Wednesday or Thursday, you know. Very unique situation. I'm sure that helps when recruiting for Pittsburgh to be able to share that complex with an NFL team.
Palco got rid of it quick. Too quick. Couldn't get it out. To his intended receiver, Derek Kinder. Here's Jim.
Well, every week, guys, Tyler Palco takes his offensive line to dinner to show his appreciation for that protection. And this week, being Thanksgiving, they had an extra special dinner. He took them to the Cheesecake Factory. You know about those portions. They're extra large. They said it was some scene. Five linemen and Palco sitting there. They ate so much, no one even had room for that cheesecake dessert. Well, okay, maybe they did, a couple of them.
I doubt Rob Pettini, that 335-pounder from Rumson, New Jersey, left tackle. I'm sure he got a little...
He'll squeeze something in there.
If he had to.
He'll be all right.
Third and six now. More pressure. Paco has never settled and threw, but he able to run and hurdle the defender, keep it going, get the first down at the 45. Gain of 15. Never a play dead. Pac-Man, what happened?
Now, when you play man-to-man coverage and you blitz like this, you got to get to the quarterback because Paco, good recognition and getting downfield. He hurdles Pac-Man Jones, but he's got linemen running down. But look at the athleticism on Tyler Paco to go up over the number one tackler on West Virginia's defense, Pac-Man Jones.
Beautiful run to the 45. Now play action. Looking long for Lee. Comes back underneath, and it is intercepted. It should have been intercepted by Jameel Adai. He couldn't hang on to it, but Lawrence Adina does come up with the interception.
Adai this time comes from the inside. Now, you keep your eye on number four right there. He's coming from the inside, and he makes a good break on the ball, Kirk, right here. Boom! He should have had it, but it bounces up in the old tip drill, right?
And watch, see Tyler Palco? Right there, he's trying to talk to Eric Gill, saying he's expecting him to continue to come across. Continue to come across. Miscommunication, and Adai stepped right in there. Probably should have had the interception, but at least he put it up in the air.
But that's the tip drill at defensive backs practice all the time.
First down, the senior KJ Harris. In the backfield. Good play off the end by John Clermond. He's going to learn the position in season. Redshirt freshman made the play.
One thing, when you are a young offense, sometimes you have to learn on the field. Right here, he's throwing the football to where he thinks Gill is going to go. And sometimes as a receiver, you're taught in zone coverage to break it down and in man coverage to continue to come across.
last featured in this series. He's brought down after getting about 5 yards. Thomas Smith there with the tackle. Let's keep coming back to what West Virginia is trying to do offensively. KJ Harris has caught the ball once out of the backfield, once as a receiver. They need to find other receiving sources here tonight. But with the absence of Chris Henry, their big catch man.
KJ Harris is an individual who can catch it out of the backfield, but I've been really impressed for this first quarter and 5 minutes down to the second quarter. The way they have mixed up the play calling. This is a team that came in averaging 258 yards a game on the ground. They love to run, but tonight they've shown the ability to throw even without Chris Henry.
Marshall 7 of 8 passing. His third down toss, receiver slip, and it's incomplete. Dwayne Thompson, who next year might very well be the Mountaineer quarterback, is in there as a receiver tonight, part of missing Chris Henry. He slipped coming out of his break, and West Virginia will punt it. Rich Rodriguez was not really sharing Thanksgiving greetings with Phil Brady, the punter, after the last kick. Wasn't happy with him. This one not much better. Out of bounds at the 28-yard line, just a kick of 27 yards in all for Brady, who is struggling here tonight. Well, this series has had so many great games over the years. Let's go back to the backyard brawl in 1982. Old Dan Marino, one of the many retired numbers in great Pittsburgh history. Marino put on a display in that game. The Panthers ending up with the win as West Virginia missed the field goal late, 16-13. Marino, one of the 8 numbers retired here and honored at Heinz Field. And they also have those players' lockers when you walk into the Pittsburgh facility as well. Through the hole, into the secondary, Tim Murphy. 35, 37-yard carry, his longest of the season.
Every time we've seen Tim Murphy get his hands on the ball, this guy runs with a great deal of, it's almost like an attitude that he's running with tonight. He's finally healthy. There's a nice hole there that just opened up by the right side of the line, but boy, lead right now tonight, Tim Murphy running like a man with a lot of passion in his heart.
Justin Barlowski, the center, stayed with his block and allowed Murphy to make a cutoff. Anytime you get a good run like that, it's usually that center and that guard who come off the ball real well.
So I'm pulling that left leg back. He had a left hamstring problem earlier this year. Halko for the home run to Lee. Incomplete. Terrific coverage by Anthony Mims, who has been busy. This young man out of Southern California, LA's Fairfax High School.
This is something that Greg Lee, only a sophomore, needs. He's got his man beat. Look, he's slowing down, and it's not just that he's slowing down for the ball. I think he needs to continue to get downfield in a hurry. And this is, you know, a relationship. The reason I say that is it allowed Mims to come back and be able to get a hand up on the ball. But he slowed down even before that ball was in the air. He's got to continue to accelerate downfield.
Palco just 4 of 12 passing here tonight. The sophomore from Pittsburgh to his running back, Marcus Furman. Room to run. Tiptoes out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Give him 15 and another Panther first down.
Now that is a really good play by Palco because he looks downfield, not looking down, and then all of a sudden he dumps it out to Furman. Kirk, what I liked about that play, watch his eyes. Whoosh, boom, and he gets it off with a quick release. That's a good-looking play by Palco. The reason why it was a good-looking play is he did it real quick. Boom. Right out there.
And it's one of the things in these last 3 weeks he's done is he's coming off of his primary receiver and dumping it to his backs and finding his check down.
Murphy back in the game. He runs. He gets about 3 or 4 yards as they move it toward the 16. We're talking a lot about Tyler Palco, the quarterback, and his understanding of what this Pittsburgh team is trying to do. He understands what's going on here in Pittsburgh by growing up around here. Every quarterback's measured to Terry Bradshaw if you're a Steeler, or Dan Marino if you're a Panther. Very few people will ever come close to those guys. And what I'm saying is the position brings so much more scrutiny with very knowledgeable football fans. But this guy's a worker. He knows it. He's in the film room constantly. Lives football. An emerging star as a sophomore. Play action from the 17. Waits. throws it away. Everybody covered. He got rid of it before third down. What his teammates think about their quarterback.
Huddle, you know, he gets us all going and he picks us up when we're down, and you know, he's a guy who's not going to let us get down on yourself, and you know, he's not going to let us lose, and he makes us play harder. You know, you, it's the kind of guy you want to protect and, you know, work your butts off and practice for. You know, you don't ever want to see him getting hit, and you know, but you know, when he does get hit, that he's going to get up and the next play hits something else.
Here, Palco and the Panthers take timeout. Nate coming up. We got Palco here, coach from West Allegheny High School in Pittsburgh, and Marshall from Brashear High School.
Look at those quarterbacks all from this area. And I think it comes from the fact, first of all, Kirk, it's a very competitive area. These guys are all competitors. It's, they play a top-notch competition. But look at the talent on that from Western Pennsylvania alone.
That's as good as anywhere in the country, obviously. Anywhere. I mean, yeah. The history and the way guys grow up. Mike, you touched on it. Even today, they grow up and they feel that legacy. They feel that pressure, and they want to try to live up to it. Tyler Palco, to me, reminds me of a guy who's going to be in the film room. He's going to study. He's going to work hard. But then you just heard one of an All-American type offensive lineman, four-year starter, Rob Petitti, talking about he's in the huddle, first-year starter. He's got our we're listening. He has our ears pinned to everything that he is saying. I think that's rare to hear out of a sophomore quarterback coming from a senior lineman. He's a guy that's constantly communicating with his team as well.
Especially a guy who came in billed as a star, billed as a guy who's going to save the program. Yep. When Rod Rutherford struggled when Palco was a freshman, the crowd here at Heinz Field chair, we want Tyler. So he's had the buildup coming in, but those guys often aren't the ones who gain their teammates right away, and he does.
And remember, he committed before his senior year. Then what'd he do? Throw 9 passes a game with his dad and his senior year?
His dad's the head coach.
He said, yes, sir.
So now he went to one of dad's games and they're throwing it 25, 30 times.
Said, why not me, dad?
He'll be throwing or scrambling here, needing to get inside the 10 to keep the drive alive. Scrambling. Now throwing for his tight end, Gill, who was out of bounds, and the pass is incomplete. The pat's coming off from the line judge, Don Salmon, there, as Gill was out of bounds with Mike Lorello defending him. Lawrence Adina put on the pressure. We have another field goal attempt coming up.
The thing that hurts this offense is outside of Greg Lee, they don't have another go-to guy, a guy that can get off of press coverage. So if Lee can't do it, a lot of times, Tyler Palco has to scramble just to buy time to try to find another open receiver.
Josh Cummings' mom and dad come to every football game from California. What a great story that was. I met his dad in a hotel today.
Oh, he did?
What a family. Yeah. Unbelievable story.
He's covered almost 40,000 miles this year.
Can you believe that?
Yeah. 35 yards here for his second field goal of the quarter.
Aye.
Not pretty.
All right.
No pictures on the scorecard.
His dad told me it was worth 9 million miles to watch him kick that ball against Notre Dame.
Game winner there.
Woo!
It's one here to make it a 4-point game.
People everywhere are experiencing a breakthrough. Taco Bell's new Big Bell Value Menu. A new menu of filling items, like half-pound burritos and double tacos. To keep your stomach and your wallet full, think outside the bun.
Introducing the Canon Rebel T2. A sophisticated yet easy-to-use SLR that'll help you take extraordinary photographs. The new Canon T2. Once a rebel, always a rebel.
Now that special SUV you want is gift wrapped for you during your Lincoln Mercury dealer's Wishlist year-end event. Featuring Wishlist values on the most entertaining SUVs on the planet with a no-charge DVD entertainment system. You can even add Sirius satellite radio. Now get the Lincoln Aviator Luxury Package for $439 a month with a no-charge DVD entertainment system. The Wishlist special values are only here for the holidays. See your tri-state Lincoln Mercury dealer today.
Samantha, I'm home. Samantha.
Samantha. There you are.
With HBO On Demand, play Sex in the City whenever you're in the mood. HBO On Demand. Start your Sunday now.
ESPN's College Football Primetime is presented by Hitachi, the ultimate television viewing experience. And in part by Miller. There's good enough, and there's better than it has to be. Miller, good call.
We welcome you back to Heinz Field, the North Shore of Pittsburgh. A lot of other places, there will be a lot fewer people here as we were coming over the stadium.
Yeah,
lots of families,
yeah.
Blankets, hats. This is no big deal. They've done this before. Windshield near 20, it's okay. Football game. See you there. Pac-Man, Adam Jones, the kickoff. Some room to run, and he's brought down at the 36-yard line. Tackle made by Bryant. And we remind you that college football Saturday over on ESPN2. Good regional rivalry that next year will be a Big East game. Cincinnati against number 8 Louisville, and Stephon LaFors, who has continued his brilliant season since we saw him in the Orange Bowl back in October. Thanksgiving weekend presented by Hitachi, continuing on ESPN2 Saturday, 2:30 Eastern Time.
One of the best games of the day.
Absolutely. I was going to go with an upset, but Dino Garduli, the quarterback of Cincinnati, bad hand.
Yep, injured his hand in a fall coming out of his home last weekend. Rasheed Marshall chased by Charles Soleil and taken out of bounds. Well, the BCS standings presented, brought to you by Allstate. You see the top six with Utah firmly in that top six. Texas in action tomorrow against Texas A&M, and there's Boise State sitting at 7. And while the mathematic margin between 6 and 7 looks pretty big, if a team loses, they do drop a lot. Like 0.180, 0.170 the last couple of teams that have dropped out of the top six. So we could have Boise ending up in the top six. Run by Jason Colson will be a first down at the 46. That's why the Saturday night game is so important. Louisville's game remains important, because if one of those teams jumps up in the top six, they would knock either Cal or Texas out, even though they're in the top four of the BCS.
Which is absolutely ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
Absolutely.
Ludicrous to even think about.
Ridiculous to think about.
How do we feel about it?
Say nothing.
Said plenty. I think ludicrous was something.
Well,
I know. It's just... Run stop on first down as Jason Colson carried there. It's kind of interesting. We see those BCS standings, and three of the top 10 are teams not from ACC, Big East, Big 10, Big 12, Pac-10, SEC. Second and 10 for Marshall. Looking downfield, incomplete. Trying to find somebody to go to downfield. Brandon Miles, the intended receiver there, and Kirk, they are certainly missing their big play offensive guy.
Chris Henrich did it all when it came to the big plays downfield for Rasheed Marshall. Take away the 49 receptions, that's about 43% of the receptions by this West Virginia team. 811 yards, that's over 50% of the yards that Marshall's been able to come up with. They haven't been able to sustain a lot of drives, but they have come up with some unique ways to get the ball into the hands of some other people, obviously with Henry out.
Third and 10 coming up. They load up the left side, flush Marshall, and he dumps it to Colson. Nice move to pick up the first down at the 40-yard line. Gain of 14. The sophomore made that play happen.
They sent everybody downfield. And initially, Marshall wanted to go downfield, but he dumps it off. And this is why you dump it off to a tailback, is because of what he can do in a one-on-one opportunity in the open field.
And he's got nice size, 6'1", 215, and makes the good movement. I tell you what, that West Coast offense has a perfect example over there. Give it to a back and let him run.
From the 40, now Pernell Williams is in the game, and the freshman goes forward for about 4 yards.
I know KJ Harris is the superstar of this football team, but I like the way Williams and Colson are running. They look like they're much quicker. Now, maybe here comes Harris in. Now, it made me look bad, but I tell you what, he doesn't have the old that these other two guys. Now, he hasn't practiced much this week.
Right.
Again.
He's right. He's been banged up most of the year, but you're right. Williams and Colson, it's a different gear. Pernell Williams is a true freshman. You can definitely see it from up here. He explodes into the hole.
It's time. Hand to Williams. Face mask flag going to come in here as he was brought down by H.B. Blades. It'll be a 5-yarder. Yep.
Coming right off the edge there. And this is one of these things. Kyle Smith got him. It was pretty obvious right in front of the official. But one of these things where it comes down to the numbers. Are they going to run? Are they going to be able to run into so many defensive? Pitt puts everybody up to the line of scrimmage. Yet West Virginia's still coming up with ways to find some creases and seams. And a lot of it is off the cutback runs by their tailbacks.
You brought up an interesting point. They average 258 yards game rushing. That's fifth in the nation from a spread offense.
Yep.
Everybody would think that would be a passing offense. Not so fast, my friends. They like to run it from this.
Look at Pitt. They have everybody at the line of scrimmage.
Toss. Colson. See yard there. Get a good look at Tyrone Gilliard coming up for the stick with Blades. And here's Jill Arrington.
West Virginia's coach Rodriguez, he asked his players for feedback when making up his game plan every week. He asked his skill players for their top 5 plays. He asked his quarterback for their top 25 plays. He says it's important for him to know what they're comfortable with because you get better results. Now, Coach Corso, did you ever ask for input from your team players?
And I did. I asked them all the time, but I never used it.
Right.
Psychologically, it made them feel like they were part of it.
Good.
Very good.
You matter.
I'll guarantee you, John Cooper never asked you.
You're right.
Thank you.
Marshall, incomplete.
But you're right. It makes the players feel good. Coach Kidd. See ya.
I tell you, my life's on the line. I'm going with my thoughts and my assistant coaches.
Who was it? We had Tommy West that said that this week. Remember, he said, I trust the guy upstairs. The guy that studies it for a living.
I'm paying him more money.
Tommy West was talking about that with the offense as well, right? Play 10 of this drive. It'll be 3rd and 10.
This is where they really miss Chris Henry. Kind of a lob pass.
Henry suspended for violating team rules. Trying to get some underneath with Miquel Henderson. Not going to get away from the Panther defense. Salate starts it. Malcolm Postel out of New Jersey finishes it. 4th down decision for West Virginia.
But right at the snap, Salate, the defensive end. Look at him. Look at him step up and then move right to the outside to take Henderson away. And he's fortunate as a defensive end that it was into the boundary, into the short side of the field. But you could tell off his own blitz as a defensive end. He went from a 3-point to being up, kind of had his head on a swivel and located Henderson right away close to the boundary and was able to wrap him up.
It's a 44-yard field goal attempt, guys, for Brad Cooper, who made a 54-yarder against East Carolina. The conditions a lot tougher here. Wide right. No good. It was long enough, but very wide, and the Panthers gaining some momentum. They've scored the last 6 points, and they take over at their own 27-yard line. Jill will visit with Tyler Palko's parents. We'll see if the sophomore can put the Panthers on top as we continue on Thanksgiving night.
When hard work is combined with pure talent, a merely good performance is transformed into a brilliant one. It's true of every art, including the art of investing. Talk to your advisor about Oppenheimer Funds, the right way to invest.
Something smells good. Delivery?
It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
DiGiorno? Get out. You fix the oven. You fix the oven? You are handy. I'm calling Mother.
Pizza?
Introducing DiGiorno Microwave Pizza. Rises up golden brown in minutes. For oven-baked taste in a hurry, it's not delivery, it's DiGiorno. Microwave.
Microwave, huh?
At least I picked something.
Hey, who's winning? Parents, are you tired of your kids going over your family's wireless minutes?
Yeah.
And kids, tired of them hassling you just for talking?
Totally.
Well, good news. Sprint got rid of ugly overages.
Now families can talk more. Share 800 anytime minutes on two lines for just $70 a month. 100 extra minutes for just $5 means no ugly overages. And each additional line is just $10 a month.
Now you can save your money for the cleaners.
Thank you. Sprint PCS. Now that's better.
Pittsburgh defensive coordinator Paul Rhodes drawing it up, getting the attention of his guys. It's a Panther defense that has done the job here over the last couple of series. Listen up, guys, from the 26. Here goes Murphy, and not much of a game there. Tyler Palco, the quarterback who had the first ever 5-touchdown game at Notre Dame, has thrown every quarterback pass for this Pittsburgh team this year. He turned the reins after redshirting last year, and this was one of the prime recruits that Walt Harris went after, and as Lee told you earlier, was able to get an early commitment from. Second and nine. Go to the air, incomplete, intended for Lee, and let's go down to Jim.
I'm here with Tyler's father, Bob Palco. Now, we heard about the little T-shirt that he got as a baby saying future quarterback, but when did you know he was real quarterback material?
You know what, probably when he got into junior high. You know, he just had that certain presence about him that, you know, he wanted the ball in his hands all the time. So, you know, it was something that you saw at a young age, really.
Well, I'm sure as a coach, you gave him a lot of advice growing up, but is it true now that you're calling him for the advice because he's a real study of the game?
Oh, there's no doubt about that. I mean, you know, he's been doing just a tremendous job, and I don't understand sometimes when he hit it. Sometimes, you know, I have to go to him. I mean, you know, he's above me a little bit now, but, you know, we're learning. You know, in the offseason, he's teaching me the offense, so I know what he's looking at, too. So, you know, we'll keep plugging away.
How impressed are you with just how far his game has come the years he's been here at Pittsburgh?
Well, he's really improved under Coach Harris. I mean, you know, he's just elevated his game. You know, plus he's gotten physically stronger and bigger. But mentally, you know, he's grasping the game a lot more.
Well, thanks for talking to us. We can tell football is in his blood.
Thank you very much.
Jill, thank you. Gressel with the punt. That snap was better. The kick was not. Pac-Man Jones going to let it drop. Did it hit the Pittsburgh, West Virginia player on the ground of foot? Mountaineers do come up with the recovery. If it would have hit that blocker, albeit inadvertently, Pittsburgh could have recovered. And some words exchanged there between Kennard Cox and Angelo Lewis. Let's go to Chris Fowler back in the studio. Look ahead to what's coming up for the half.
It's the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report. Trevor Mark will join me here. We'll look back at Peyton Manning's brilliant day. Julius Jones, also a big day. Look to those showdowns that'll decide the ACC, the Big East, on Saturday.
Yeah, a little Syracuse, Boston College trying to get that automatic BCS berth. Tom O'Brien's done a great job there.
I'll tell you how many touchdown passes Peyton Manning threw for the Indianapolis Colts.
Plus, highlights of the traditional Tirico speech and Thanksgiving to the crew. Look forward to that.
Oh, yeah, look forward to that, huh? Thanks, guys. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. On the run, here comes Cornell Williams across the 40 and out to the 47-yard line. 19 there.
Cornell Williams is really running hard now, Kirk. But what I like here, if you watch the right side of the offensive line, that is Justice again comes out, makes a good block, Kirk. But how do you like the way that kid's running? I like him better than Harris.
Well, he's going to get upfield, and when Rich Rodriguez talked to us, he said he's a north and south guy. He always has. He's a downhill runner, and he's falling forward. That's nice. Those are some nice characteristics when you're a true freshman.
He's out. Jason Colson's in across midfield and to the 47-yard line.
Can I give
there's a lot of post-play conversation going on here. Somebody's not careful. They're going to pick up 15 yards that are going to be important in this game. Sorry, Lee.
No, I was going to give you my, is it Under Armour?
Yeah, yeah.
Under Armour.
Advantage?
Advantages?
Yes.
For the halftime.
Oh, no. That's the Home Depot.
Okay, I forgot. Home Depot adjustments. Give the ball to Williams and Colson some. Yeah. I don't know which guys are doing what, but.
Marshall here, everything covered, trying to scramble away. Play is still alive. Marshall looking to run, take it off. And picks up the first down.
That's one way to do it.
Oh, what a coach play, huh?
Yeah, this is well designed.
This is well designed.
We've seen this before on the coach's meeting room with Rich Rodriguez. I mean, he's just keeping the play alive.
Right.
But when you have this kind of athletic ability, once he gets away from pressure, that hurdle at the end after all that running, I think, showed his endurance. That's a lot to do. That offensive line, that's why they can run the football. That group up front is a talented group.
And here comes Cornell Williams across the 30 and to the 29-yard line. Remember, guys, last year they ran for 307 yards. Quincy Wilson over 200 when they beat Pittsburgh down at Morgantown.
When you go from left to right with that offensive line, career starts 18, 22, 34, 7, 21. I think there's great continuity. They're starting to dominate Pittsburgh right now up front, and it's amazing. Even without that legitimate passing game with Chris Henry, they're still able to come up with some creases against this defense.
West Virginia had some confusion. So many receivers who aren't normally in these positions. So they had to burn a timeout here. 103 seconds left. And one hot coach waiting.
He wants to play.
What's on your mind? In your head? In your heart? What will you find? What will it mean? For tomorrow? For forever? What will you be? Who will you be? How you begin to know? The University of Pittsburgh.
You see us as athletes, but first and foremost, we're students. We go to class, study, do term papers, take exams, and then we watch game film, go to practice and lift weights. We graduate with distinguished degrees and get good jobs. We're doctors, teachers, and engineers. We work in high finance and community service. Sports is the means to an end. We are student athletes, the future civic leaders of America.
Going, saying nothing. Mike Lee Kirk and Joe, happy Thanksgiving to you. Glad you're joining us here on a cold night in Pittsburgh. Mountaineers driving up four. They've done it on the ground, but that time, Clint Session, the middle linebacker out of Pompano Beach, Florida, comes up and makes the play, a loss of yardage. Third and about 13 coming up. Rodriguez was just hot at his wide receiver, Eddie Jackson, for not being in the right spot on the last play. Second and 14, I beg your pardon. Marshall throws it away. Pittsburgh sideline saying he was not out of the tackle box. Referee says he was. Joe Clermont out of Tampa made the pressure.
But Clermont does a nice job of staying home and realizing that Marshall is better off getting outside of the pocket. He stays at home, stays to the outside, and forces Marshall to stay inside a pocket and revert back to the other side to just throw it away.
That's a bad call. He was clearly not out of the tackle box because the ball was on that right half. When you're scrambling, once you leave the tackle box, then it doesn't matter where you end up. But he never left it. Third and 14, he's out of the tackle box now. He's got a lot of room to run. Picks up a block. And has the first down at the 16-yard line. Clint Session in pursuit. Couldn't get there. Gain of 18.
Rashid Marshall has got a fifth gear. Watch this play right here. They block the defensive end to the inside. Left tackle Michael Watson does. But then right here, Kirk, This is accelerating. I'm telling you, Randall L. of the Pittsburgh Steelers, if you're an NFL scout, get this guy in your football team somewhere. What'd you think?
I think when you play man coverage on third and long against Rasheed Marshall, you better sack him or he's going to run for 25 yards downfield.
He's got seven carries, 52 yards. The ball's on the ground here and recovered by Marshall. The snap never got back to him.
You don't think the center thought he was underneath him, do you?
I know it's cold and you're numb, but usually don't you feel the guy's hands?
That was a lost control there.
Tim Brown, otherwise.
Timmy's entitled to that after 34 career starts.
From the 17, Marshall, pressure, pumping, throwing, incomplete. They're very often able to make some big plays on these plays that break down, and the athletic ability of go up and get it, Chris Henry, those are the plays where I think it's kind of showing the most tonight.
Mike, at the same time, Miguel Henderson is a guy, he's a senior, he's been around. I mean, these guys have to step up. Eddie Jackson's a senior, Bolden is a young guy, but they all, the size advantage that they have should work out for them down in this red zone area against, especially man coverage from Pitt.
Third and 12, and they tried to run for it. And the tackle at the 14. Pittsburgh bench really getting frustrated. They wanted a flag. West Virginia should take a timeout here with about 3 seconds left.
And then kick the field goal.
And let the half run out.
I think that call was setting up a field goal. Except he went
too far.
Right, too far to the right hash mark.
They'll take a timeout with 4 seconds left, or two. Now officially it ran down two, while Harris said call it both ways. Well, of course, it's Thanksgiving. I hope you've had a wonderful Thanksgiving dinner. And we are always, what, it's our seventh year now doing Thanksgiving Eve. We're the dessert on Thanksgiving night. Later on tonight, the guys will present out pies to the MVPs.
Pecan.
Pecan pie for you.
Hot apple pie.
Hot apple pie.
Yeah.
We did get a surprise, though.
Oh, yeah.
Rick Trickett, the offensive line coach for West Virginia, when we were down in Morgantown for the Syracuse game, his wife, Tara Jo, and some of the assistant coaches of the West Virginia, their wives, they made some of their specialties and brought them in for us to sample. Well, she brought us some of these great desserts. So that's our...
Think that we've been saying that offensive line is block and roll because she brought us desserts. Might be right.
They might be right. They are great.
Smell
you
it.
Those?
Yeah, we'll get into that at halftime.
Oh.
We'll visit Wait, that.
There's a reason it's been down at this end. Because as Chris Fowler wanted to know, there's Rick, the offensive line coach.
Oh, that is great stuff.
Fowler,
one of the best offensive line coaches in the country.
Fowler's talking about a record, NCAA record being broken.
I don't know. He wanted to know how much turkey you ate, and it was, we lost count.
Well, Marty, tell him about Marty.
Well, after his 31-yard field goal here for Cooper. One of two, good from 26, missed from 44, here from 31. High snap, good hold, kick block. Memories of Leon Lett on Thanksgiving Day, get away. They do, it's halftime. Momentum for Pittsburgh here at the break. Down four, Jill Arrington has their head coach.
Well, Coach Harris, you've only gotten two field goals so far. What are you going to have your offense do to get into the end zone a little bit in a second?
I think we're a little giddy. I think we're a little too fired up. I think our young quarterback's got to relax a little bit. I think he's putting too much pressure on himself. We've got to calm down, take care of our business, and we'll be okay. Great job by our defense that drive.
That's right, and that blocked play, how big was that blocked kick just now?
Huge. Huge. Thank you.
All right, Coach, thanks a lot.
Pittsburgh will get the ball first to start the third quarter. West Virginia leading by four as Kirk devours the dessert.
Oh, that's not right!
With Chris Fowler.
Oh, you're
killing.
I know the coach is going to stuff leftovers in his carry-on bag for the long flight to L.A. I know his M.O. Welcome to our Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report. Trev and Mark alongside our MVP is Lee Davis, Reese's wife, sending the leftovers here, the excellent sweet potatoes, the desserts back here. since ESPN ran out of turkey about 2 in the afternoon. I don't want to say anything,
but
Lee, thank you. You came to the rescue. Wow. What about the first half, guys?
Well, the first half, if you look at West Virginia's defense, they've done a fabulous job of disrupting the passing lanes and giving Tyler Pelko, the Pittsburgh quarterback, multiple fronts. What the Panthers have to do in the second half is establish themselves on first and second down. Too many third and seven plus, and it's tough for an offense when it's third and seven, third and eight, third and nine to overcome that situation.
And Pittsburgh's lucky to be down only 4. I mean, you look at it right now, special teams been bad. They've turned the ball over. But I think Tim Murphy's the guy they need to go back to. You mentioned Tyler Pelko not played as well early in this game, getting a little pressure, having to move around. Tim Murphy, tell you what, I like the way this guy runs. He runs hard, Mayday.
What do you think of the brawl so far, Trev? Tell me about the brawl.
It's not really a brawl. It's more of a dance.
Too giddy is that Walt Harris's diagnosis.
Well, it's a little bit of a
seems too
tapping,
giddy.
Sort of.
Hey, they might be giddy here in the Nutmeg State because Connecticut is 7-4 expecting a bowl bid. Huskies go to Sunge and come away with a hard-fought victory. Peyton Manning just continues to be brilliant. Dan Marino's record is in deep trouble. Drew Henson on his first start, he was in deep trouble.
Pay attention! Sunday NFL Countdown presented by Old Spice, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
It's not your job.
It's not your lipstick. It's not your hair.
It's your watch that tells most about who you are. The Couture Collection by Seiko. The heart of a sports watch, the soul of a fashion watch.
Come over, baby. Whole lot of steak is going on.
Applebee's Steak Stampede.
Steak, baby, steak. Eating good in the neighborhood.
ESPN Original Entertainment presents.
NASCAR's gotta have talent. And your magic on the asphalt.
Barry Pepper stars as Dale Earnhardt 3. Premieres Saturday, December 11th, 9 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
ESPN College Game Day is back in Los Angeles for the lowdown on Notre Dame versus USC.
We know USC's got good runners. We know they got everything, but they only have one Matt Leinart.
College Game Day, Saturday at 10:30 on ESPN.
You see us as athletes, but first and foremost, we're students. We go to class, study, do term papers, take exams, and then we watch game film, go to practice and lift weights. We graduate with distinguished degrees and get good jobs. We're doctors, teachers, and engineers. We work in high finance and community service. Sports is the means to an end. We are student athletes, the future civic leaders of America.
Yo!
Long Island, call Connecticut and talk as long as you like. Newark, gossip with the Bronx for hours. Westchester, call Florida and conference in California. Because with Optimum Voice, you can talk to anyone, anywhere, for as long as you like. Unlimited local, regional, and long-distance calling for one low monthly rate of $34.95. Available exclusively for Optimum Online subscribers. Get enhanced voicemail along with other popular calling features, all included in one low price. Plus, now you can change your feature settings or listen to messages with the click of a mouse using My Optimum Voice. So now everyone in the tri-state area can be heard throughout the United States.
Yo, Saskatoon!
And even Canada. Unlimited local and long distance calling in the U.S. and Canada for one low monthly rate of $34.95. Call 1-866-55-GET-OV for the deal that has everyone talking. Optimum Voice.
Welcome to the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report.
At halftime, the Mountaineers on the road, leading the Panthers 10-6. Their BCS bowl hopes still alive, pending the outcome of Saturday's BC-Syracuse game. Well, what can you say to describe Peyton Manning? Astounding might be one adjective. He is on pace for a 60-touchdown pass season. He could have broken the record, or at least shared the record, of 7 touchdown passes in a game if they hadn't pulled him in the third quarter in Detroit today. Manning and the Colts are just brilliant. This is a 5th straight 4DT or TD-plus game. It's Brandon Stokely over the middle. This was just pitch and catch against the helpless Lions.
And look who he looks for again. Guess what? Brandon Stokely again. That's his 2nd touchdown pass of the day.
And, you know, I got to give this offensive line some credit, too, Mark. How many times does Peyton Manning actually get hit? The offensive line, great job. Again, Brandon Stokely there across the middle. Does he get in? Dives into the end zone. 25-yard touchdown for Stokely.
All right, Stokely's got the hat trick. Where's the love for Marvin Harrison? Finally, Peyton hooks up with him here. 13 yards, 27-6. It's a woodshed beatdown in Detroit. And then Harrison again, 10-yarder, 34-9. Finally, you know, Jim Sorgi comes out of the third quarter after Manning threw number six here. This Harrison again, he could add, what, 8, 9. They'd still be playing. He would have stayed in the game.
Called off the dogs.
Unbelievable. Peyton Manning and the Colts roll on. They're 8-3 now as Detroit stumbles to 4-7. Joey Harrington throwing for just 156 yards. Kevin Jones a yard short of 100. So Dan Marino holds the all-time record for TD passes in a season. Here's how Manning compares at this point in the season. Now, Marino got hot late, but at this point in that season, 84, he had only 30. Only 30. Incredible. But 60.
Well, Dan Marino didn't have the running game that they have. Remember, they've got a guy called Edgerrin James they give the ball to a lot in Indianapolis. But Danny Marino, more passing yards. But, hey, two great quarterbacks. Peyton Manning will be in the Hall of Fame someday, guaranteed.
Next 2 weeks, that record should fall. On the other end of the spectrum, Drew Henson, his first start for Dallas was not a good one. Scoreless game against the Bears here. And that's Julius Jones, the ex-Domer, darting up the middle, 33 yards, 7-0 Cowboys. And Vinny had to come in as Henson was pulled at halftime in a 7-7 game. Vinny at age 41. Booed when he came in, but he engineers the drive in the fourth quarter.
The play-action pass here finds Darian Barnes in for the touchdown. I thought it was Illinois. At first, when I turned the TV, I thought that was the Illini.
They played like Illinois a little bit. It's a cheap shot. Throwbacks to 1946, and here's Jones in the end zone for the touchdown. Julius Jones, 4 yards, 21-7 Cowboys. Parcells' team, 4-7. Still a long shot for the playoffs. Got to wonder about Henson, who's benched halfway through his first start. Stay tuned. This morning in the Big East, Dan Orlovsky and the Connecticut Huskies trying to enhance their bowl credibility against the State University of New Jersey. Aaron Shawell drops back, throws deep. Oh. Trent Moses, great circus catch, 87-yard touchdown. Moses, a big game in his final game for the Scarlet Knights, giving the touchdown right there. But Orlovsky, too much offense. Dan Murray had a big game, couple touchdowns.
Wonderful job of play action pass. Rolling out of the pocket, finds Dan Murray. Touchdown, 32 yards. UConn takes the lead, 35-28.
It was a six-point game. Final seconds here. Ryan Hart, and a tough day. Tipped, incomplete. UConn wins it. Pretty impressive story. Third year in their full top on a 1A scholarship to get the ice water bath at 7-4. They should be bound for the Continental Tire Bowl against the Tar Heels. Good season for UConn, quietly.
First season as a Big East football member, you get to a bowl game. Outstanding by Randy Edson.
Rutgers stumbles down the stretch with 5 losses. We'll come back. Look ahead at Saturday after this.
The Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report is powered by Pontiac and the first ever G6, the next official performance machine of the NCAA.
First ever G6. The next official performance machine of the NCAA.
Katie was sure of her cholesterol plan. She took medication, she ate right and ran. Yet it wasn't enough to get bad cholesterol low. What's this? I'm still here in the land of no? Switch to Crestor, her doctor said. You're not to blame. All cholesterol drugs simply aren't the same. When Crestor performed in a head-to-head test, its lowering effect was clearly the best. Crestor's proven effective. That's well understood. Would you like to try it? Why, yes. Yes, I would.
Ask your doctor about Crestor. Crestor is not for everyone, including people with liver disease and women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. Simple blood tests are needed to check for liver problems. Tell your doctor about other medications you are taking, or if you experience muscle pain or weakness, as they may be a sign of serious side effects.
Since Katie switched to Crestor, her cholesterol's much less. With Crestor and diet, it's the land of success. Get your free trial today, and you just might declare, I'm a Crestor success. Now you're getting somewhere.
This week's Pontiac game changing performance. You go to the Alabama-Auburn game. Tide led 6-0 when Jason Campbell captures momentum by finding Devin Oromashadu. He hauls it in for 51 yards. That was in the third quarter, which set up Cadillac Williams' go-ahead touchdown. Auburn wins it 21-13. That is your Pontiac game-changing performance. $5,000 from Pontiac to the General Scholarship Fund of Auburn. A pretty impressive margin of victory for the Auburn.
And Ohio State fans must get on and vote, because every week we have an Ohio State fan.
Teddy Ginn Jr., you think beating Michigan, that might have gotten more votes.
You'd have thought.
All right, guys, a couple of BCS conference championships being fought for on Saturday in the Big East and the ACC. Will start in the Big East, where Syracuse at 5-5 must win to become bowl eligible. Paul Pasqualoni, the embattled Orange coach, trying to fight for his job. Walter Reyes, he says his arm's going to have to be ripped out of his socket for him not to play. He's still listed as questionable with a shoulder injury. And Boston College is going to have to go with backup Matt Ryan, the redshirt freshman at quarterback, because Paul Peterson has a broken bone in his hand. Syracuse is a terrible team on the road. They've lost 11 straight conference games away from the Dome. It means so much for BC. How do you see this playing out?
Well, I like Boston College in this game. You mentioned Paul Peterson being out, but I think the good thing for Boston College is L.V. Whitworth is finally healthy, and they're running the ball, being much more physical. The other side of the ball, you mentioned Walter Reyes. Very interesting. Boston College, kind of overlooked constantly, is their defense. 19th in the nation in run defense. We've talked about freshmen all year, quarterbacks and running backs. How about Brian Toll, freshman middle linebacker, outstanding at stopping the run? I think that's the bottom line. They shut down the run of Syracuse and force them to become one-dimensional. I like Boston College.
I like Boston College in this game also, but I like if Syracuse can get that emotional stability and come out in this football game as they did against Pittsburgh. They beat Pittsburgh. UConn, they beat UConn. They played Florida State right down to the wire, but the key is on the road. Can they play in the elements? Can they play on the road at Boston College? I think this game's going to come down who can run the football successfully late in the football game, and I believe that to be Boston College. You have a better offensive line.
And again, if West Virginia can keep this lead against Pittsburgh, win the ball game, they'll be watching very closely on Saturday, hoping somehow Syracuse can come up with the road victory and propel the Mountaineers to the Big East BCS bowl bid. In the ACC, a very old rivalry, Virginia Tech and Virginia, they battle for the Commonwealth Cup, but they're in the same conference for the first time since 35. They play in Blacksburg, where the Hokies have been tough, and late in the season, where Virginia Tech, unlike recent years, is not swooning. They're getting stronger as the season gets later.
And they're getting stronger because of Mike Emo. I mean, I think that's the difference with this team right now. You talk about Brian Randall. He's had a nice year, a little bit up and down, but he got good and he got better, I think, when Mike Emo finally got healthy. Mike Emo has been that stabilizing factor for this team. I think you look at their defense. This is the whole key for me. This both teams, Mark, want to run the football. Both teams want to establish a line of scrimmage. Can Mike Emo run the football versus Virginia's 15th-ranked run defense? I think it's the whole story. If he can't run, I like Virginia in the game.
I think it's those four linebackers led by Ahmad Brooks in the middle. Those guys are big, physical, 6'4", 250 pounds, can run sideline to sideline. If the Virginia Tech offense can run the ball, you're right, Trev, they will have success at home. But I think the other thing is Marcus Hagans, the quarterback for Virginia, when he's under pressure in a big game, this team didn't respond very well against Miami, against Florida State. Now it's another marquee game against Virginia Tech. Can this team step up to the plate and play well? I want to see if they can play well on the road versus a very good football team.
I meant to say stabilizing, by the way.
Stabilizing? Yeah. I knew what you meant.
Yeah. It's
kind of a provisional pick. Do you like the Hokies? Do you like the Cavaliers?
I do like Virginia. I
like Virginia.
I think Marcus Hagan gets it done.
Do you? Okay. I'll break the tie. Just say the Hokies at home. And it would be a great game if they win this game. Great
it's
game at Miami.
For the,
nothing stable about the special teams play in this game. The histrionics continue. The big block by the Panthers at the end of the first half keeps it to a 4-point West Virginia margin. We'll come back after this.
The Cooper Zeon 2XS Ultra High Performance Tire. Made to perform on the skid pad, the slalom, the track, and in the real world. Cooper Tires. Don't give up a thing. Go to CooperTire.com for more information and a dealer near you.
Home improvement looking hopeless? Meet the Straight Line Intersect, the only laser that just sticks and automatically levels three laser lines to reveal your starting point for perfectly square results. So tame the tiles, sharpshoot the shelves, conquer the collage, and take out the trash. Intersect, another advanced electronic tool from Straight Line.
A great education begins with dreams. A great university makes them possible.
At West Virginia University, students are designing microchip sensors to build the country's smartest bridge, producing an Emmy Award-winning documentary, developing laser techniques to study plasma propulsion, creating a new generation of cancer drugs. Start living your dreams at West Virginia University, where greatness is learned.
These are tough times for the MTA, facing billions in deficits, and they're raising fares again. Now Mayor Bloomberg wants the MTA to hand over valuable waterfront property for a Westside football stadium at an undisclosed price, instead of selling the land to the highest bidder. With higher fares and service cuts, that's not a deal New Yorkers can afford. Long Island commuters should not have to pay the price for a football stadium. Say no to a Westside stadium.
It's just one now after another. Now is why Cablevision built Optimum, the most astonishing digital network in the nation. IO Interactive Optimum. Optimum Online, super high-speed internet. Optimum Voice, flat rate, unlimited calling. Everything you ever wanted to see, hear, and say at the speed of, well, now. Welcome to now. Welcome to Optimum.
The Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report is powered by Pontiac and the first ever G6, the next official performance machine of the NCAA.
Saturday night, primetime showcase for number 10 Boise State, which is number 7 in the BCS, the unbeaten Broncos visiting Nevada. Boise State could be headed for a nice Liberty Bowl showdown with Louisville. You like that game, guys?
I like that game, and Louisville wins by 25 or 30.
Oh, wow. Kidding.
Absolutely.
Really? What, 175? That'd be a lot of fun, though. That's if Boise doesn't crash the BCS. Second half, straight ahead from Pittsburgh. That's the touchdown from Jason Colson. Mountaineers lead by 4.
Have you ever started a car from across the road? Given your backseat passengers a tan? Or driven a four-door like a sports car? Introducing the first ever G6 from Pontiac. New models are arriving daily, and now you can get one with a great offer like this. Be the first. See your Pontiac dealer.
Ha! Try being Kris Kringle's little brother. Man, you never win. Even now, I'm not good at this holiday stuff. But with BestBuy.com, it's easy for us regular guys to pull off holiday miracles, too.
It's for me. I'll get it.
I thought their stores were big, but, oh, man, they have even more great stuff online. There's only one Kris Kringle. For the rest of us, there's Best Buy.
Golden liquid applied sparingly only adds to the patina. That's a happy accident, courtesy of the High Life.
All season long, we remind you to register and vote for the singular All-America Player of the Week. Now, as always, this week's nominees will be presented on the 1 a.m. Sports Center. To get involved, to nominate and vote, you just got to text the word player to 64-44 on your cell phone. Back to Mike, Lee, Kirk, and Jill. The second half from Pittsburgh. Mountaineers up 10-6.
Hi, Kris. Thank you, Mr. Fallon.
We'll see him on 84 heading west, right?
Safe travels to Southern California. College game day comes to you from USC Notre Dame this weekend. Let's game track you through the first 30 minutes here. Rasheed Marshall from Pittsburgh, his final game of a regular season. 147 total yards for the senior. This elusive scramble, part of the story. Marshall's the leading West Virginia rusher with 52 yards. We've had a blocked field goal, a couple of bad punts, This has not exactly been a special teams clinic. J.J. Horn, the block there. It will be Pittsburgh ball to start the third. Mike, Lee, Kirk, and Jill, glad to be with you here on Thanksgiving night. And by the way, while we have a second, happy Thanksgiving to all of our families around the country as they watch. Look ahead to the second half here, guys.
Well, the big thing that I've noticed is that Pittsburgh's offense is struggling. You can look at Tyler Palko and his numbers, but it's the receivers, I think. They're going up against a West Virginia defense that's going to press them, and their receivers right now, with the exception of Greg Lee, can't get away from the coverage. Therefore, Palko, as a rhythm quarterback, is in trouble. They have to find somebody in the second half to be able to get him into his rhythm by getting off of that coverage and also being able to run the football.
Now Lee's Home Depot.
My Home Depot adjustments. First of all, run Williams and Colson, the two tailbacks, but also play action on first and down. First and 10, they've run a running play on every down on first and 10, except one time in the first half, so West Virginia. Now blitz and do what Kirk said. Pittsburgh cannot pick up the blitz from West Virginia, but you got to spy Palko because he can run. And then screens and draws, little plays that Palko can give the ball off to these other guys. And then last but not least, I am really impressed with Paul Rhodes' defensive game plan against West Virginia. They're in the ball game because of that. That's what I would do right there.
Lee's Home Depot coaching adjustments. Paul Rhodes has had good defenses.
Oh,
doesn't
yeah.
have the number of people that he used to have. You know, guys like Ramon Walker and Spencer, Shante Spencer's in the NFL. Cox, Moore, Hayes had some very good players over the years here in Pittsburgh. Not those kind of players just yet. But performance here in the first half. Brad Cooper set to kick it off for the Mountaineers toward Marcus Furman, who fields it at the three. Stutter step, stopped, and is stopped shy of the 20. Special teams awful in this game. Here's Jill Arrington.
Well, and talking to Coach Rodriguez after halftime, he's so very unhappy with that blocked kick. He says when we get in the red zone, we have to have points to look for his playmakers to make plays. Specifically, he said, Rashid Marshall. He says he's the game, but he needs him to take it to the next level because they want the win.
Jill, has the wind died down a little bit? I know it's still cold for you. Has it died down a little bit from earlier?
Absolutely, Mike. It's totally died down. It's feeling kind of nice up here.
You don't look too chilly down there, girl.
I'm good. Thanks for the hot chocolate, by the way. I'm glad you guys hooked me up there.
No problem.
Anything for you, Jill. First and 10 from the Panthers, from their own 16. Here is a little play action. First down, Palko trying to stretch the defense. Downfield for Lee. Did not bring it in. It bounced out at the 45-yard line. Coverage with Anthony Mims again.
There's the guy that's been the one guy that's been able to get away from West Virginia's man coverage has been Greg Lee, and it seems like it's always where he gives him the stem move to the outside and then gets upfield, and the ball just overthrown there. But Greg Lee is the one guy that Pitt has, Lee, in this second half that can make a play in the passing game.
Remember, Walt Harris said he went down to Tampa and nobody offered him a scholarship except Pittsburgh. Well, that is an amazing stat from Tampa, Florida. Good-looking athlete.
They said they saw him play basketball, and they thought, you know what, let's sign this guy.
Yeah.
Second down and 10, a run for just a couple of yards. And we'll have third and 8 coming up. Tim Murphy has carried most of the first half. And let's take a look at the Hitachi first half stats. West Virginia, 118 rushing yards. Great dominance in that stat last year with Quincy Wilson, who's now on the practice squad of the Atlanta Falcons. You see the yards per rush too high for the defenses to like. It's been a well-played game. We talked about the nickname, the backyard brawl. Jill mentioned how, in light of what's happened the last week, the teams were warned by their coaches. Only 3 flags and all 5-yard penalties so far. Third and 8. Palko has some time. He's got nobody open, though. Waiting, hoping, finding, incomplete. And Pac-Man Jones was sitting on that and almost had a pick 6.
Goes back to my initial point here to start the second half that nobody is getting away from coverage. And I challenge you, imagine being Tyler Palko and you're trying to look downfield and you're trying to find somebody to throw the football to. Nobody can get open. I mean, he was looking off to the right. It looks like Del Sardo is open, but it's on the other side. They don't have anybody open. Tyler Palko had all day to throw, but no one to throw the football to.
And that's not really open because we're watching the coverage. Right. There's a guy in front of him. That's just a good job. Russell able to get it away. Pac-Man Jones will let it hit, and he'll have to let it go now. It'll go down to the 30. You see the penalty marker back there by the kicker. They ran into him again, but this one will not be enough to pick up a first down. The punt was 52 yards.
Not going to have a better net than 52.
It will be declined.
Personal foul.
Now they say.
Well, the pitch sideline is going to decline. I think we all saw no personal foul signal from the referee at the start. So it will be 15, and the drive will stay alive.
Forget about that 52 net. I want to see if this was actually roughing.
Oh.
My word.
Oh. Yes.
My word. No, again, Thanksgiving. Officials in the giving mood tonight, evidently.
L.J. Montanar cannot be faulted for that.
That was an absolute atrocious call.
That was really bad.
I mean.
All right, let's regroup here. Let's see what Pittsburgh can do here.
Ooh.
First and 10 from the 33. Try to establish a run because they're not getting much when they go to three wide receivers in the passing game, and just 2 yards there for the junior out of Ohio, Tim Murphy. Adam Lenort made that tackle.
You know, Mike, you brought up a very good point about the sportsmanship in this ball game. I got to compliment the presidents of South Carolina and Clemson of not going to a bowl game. You know what? That set a big, big sigh of release from one of the coaches who didn't have to worry about that anymore. But boy, what a lesson to be learned.
Absolutely.
No postseason.
Everybody involved.
Palko, as you saw, struggling, able to get a completion, but a couple of yards shy of a first down for Lee. The ball was clearly down as Greg reeled in his fourth catch of the night.
That's been Greg Lear, nobody. Tyler Palko has struggled tonight. A lot of it has to do with the kind of defense that West Virginia is playing. They have an opportunity here by playing the 3-3-5. They put a lot of people in coverage. They've also mixed up and blitzed at times. He has found Greg Lee downfield. He has made some plays at times with his feet, being able to pick up some yards there, the athletic ability, but it's been a tough night for him to find his rhythm. Walt Harris believes in a quarterback being in rhythm, and West Virginia is disrupting that rhythm so far.
So third and two, they go play action, try to go downfield for Lee. He gets it again at the 30. How many 20-plus yard catches did this guy make? 29 there again in front of Anthony Bibb.
And hey, Kirk, Mike, how about nice play action on first and 10? Whoop, nice little fake, Kirk, and that gives him the chance to set his feet. Watch him.
And the offensive line's been doing a great job of protecting. I don't know, if you're going to defend Lee, take away the inside post. That, he's been killing Mims. The only passes they've converted downfield is it post for 20 or 30 yards. Might want to take away that inside and make him go in another direction.
First down run with Murphy. Tim takes it to the 26-yard line, a gain of 4. So that will get Greg Lee to 86 yards for the night, guys, and take him over 1,000 yards here on the season. Not too bad for an unrecruited man.
I like the way Walt Harris is calling the game now. He looks like he's got a nice rhythm of draw, a little deep pass, a little flare pass real quick. Obviously, the penalty helped him, but at least right now they look like they got some momentum, and Walt does, has a system going, playing calling.
Murphy,
right there.
Nice job seeking the hole there. A face mask flag comes in as well, and it will be a first down for Pittsburgh.
Now that one's got to be 15. I mean, this guy, it looked to me that Ben Lynch not only locked on unintentionally, it looked like he started to pull pretty good.
Personal foul. Face mask. 92 defense, half the distance to the goal. First down.
It's the second time he did it. He made the signal without letting us know it was the big one. Personal foul.
It looks like it's Ben Lynch right there grabbing a hold, and now he's pulling. Once you get caught with your hand caught in there and then you're pulling, if they see it, that's going to be 15 yards.
And I want everybody there to remind themselves about that atrocious call on the punt, because Pittsburgh would not be down there if it wasn't for that official's poor call.
First and 10 from the 11. They can get a first down at the 1. Here comes Murphy to the right side, running with authority into the 6. A 5-yard first down game. Again, the importance of this game. With a win, Pittsburgh would get to 2 losses in the league at 4-2, would drop West Virginia to 4-2, and would have to root for Syracuse to beat Boston College, as the guys were talking about on Saturday. Then you'd have a four-way tie at 4-2, and later on we'll explain what would happen there. But the winner tonight keeps BCS hopes alive. Five for a first down, six for a touchdown. Murphy gets to the two.
It's funny how you catch a break on special teams. You make a throw downfield, and all of a sudden the offensive line's walking around in that huddle with their chest out. You know, it's just so funny how different things can be off of a break that you catch from the official, just based on the attitude of an offensive line.
Pittsburgh took time out here well before the play clock ever became in question. Here before 3rd and 2. They talk it over. Let us remind you about college football Saturday, as our Thanksgiving weekend presented by Hitachi continues. Boise State, Jared Zabransky, the quarterback, trying to complete the 11-0 perfect season, taking on Nevada. College football Saturday presented by Crestor is also available on ESPN HD. Call your local cable operator, DirecTV, or Dish Network today. Game time 7:45 Eastern with Ron, Mike, and Aaron from Reno.
And if Utah gets the BCS and Boise goes to the Liberty Bowl, I want you to guarantee, which is New Year's Eve, 3:30, Mike, on ESPN.
Yes, sir.
I highly recommend you watch Boise State in Louisville in the longest game of the year.
The AutoZone Liberty Bowl.
Watch it on ESPN. I mean, what time?
3:30 Eastern.
If Boise plays,
it'll be over by 8.
It'll be over by 8. But I'll tell you what, it'll be one of the most enjoyable games you'll ever watch on ESPN television. Boise against Louisville.
It's got the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl right behind it.
We got to hurry it up. The only thing about Boise, if you don't roll the blue turf out, I don't know if Boise can play that great offense without the blue turf.
Chick-fil-A did not invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Now we got it in once a year.
They got to get that in.
Here is 3rd and 1, empty backfield here. Murphy becomes one of the extra receivers. Darrell Strong is also in the game. Palco to Strong, couldn't hang on at the goal line. Trying to hit the freshman who's 6'5". They're on 3rd down, and they're going to go for the field goal here on 4th down. You know, while we were doing the promo and talking about Boise, I didn't understand that timeout. With momentum going, you only needed a yard or so for the first down, about a yard and a half.
I think he wanted to make sure that he called the right play. That's my opinion.
Okay.
I think he wanted to take his time to make sure. Look, I got to make sure I got the right play. I'm not so sure that was the right play, although the gentleman dropped it. But I agree with this call right here, because I think it's going to be a battle of field goals, and he might win this game 12-10.
Cummings from 20. He's made 2 tonight. Good job in the hole again. And he knocks that one through. It's a one-point game.
It is easy for us to sit up here, but the momentum that they had and the way they were running the football there on 1st and 2nd down, well, it would have been nice to see that line have a chance to open that up into the end zone.
15 yards there. That was called roughing the kicker. Five alive. One-point game.
Trailers don't have anti-lock brakes, crumple zones, or airbags. That's why we designed the new Ford Super Duty with the only integrated trailer brake controller, part of our exclusive tow command system. Because what good is towing a 19,200-pound trailer if you can't control it? This is the next Ford Super Duty, built Ford tough.
Critics hail Alexander.
The king lives!
Alexander is the best film of the year.
Conquer your fear, and you'll conquer death!
Oliver Stone has done it again.
It takes strong men to rule.
Colin Farrell is majestic.
Alexander!
Powerful.
No one's spoken like you to me!
An Oscar-caliber performance.
The world is yours!
Alexander.
In the end, all that matters is what you've done.
Directed by Oliver Stone. Rated R.
I pulled into Nazareth, was feeling about half past dead. I just need some place.
More bars in more places. That's the goal of Singular's All Over Network, with the largest digital voice and data coverage in America. Thanks to Singular and AT&T Wireless joining forces. Welcome to the new Singular. We're raising the bar.
What we did was the same thing American soldiers have been doing for generations. Soldiers now and soldiers then. There's the same courage, determination, and willingness to serve. What's changed is our equipment, our technology. But the spirit of a soldier, that's never changed. And that's what makes the difference.
It's a hard-fought football game, a lot of intensity.
The backyard brawl, the biggest game of West Virginia season.
It's a clash of cultures. You got the Mines versus the Mills, you know, the Mills of Pittsburgh versus the Mines from West Virginia.
The time is now and it's here, so get ready.
And it has been ever tight so far. West Virginia scored the first 10, Pittsburgh the last 9 on 3 field goals, a one-point game. Oh. Sky kick that is fielded at the 35 and brought out to the 43-yard line for the Mountaineers by Hykee Johnson. You see the West Virginia players from this area, 70 miles north from Morgantown. And a couple of Panthers are West Virginians, including Tyrone Gilliard, who will be stepping onto the field at safety, trying to slow down Rasheed Marshall and this Mountaineer offense.
This also goes to the fact that Rich Rodriguez told us there wasn't a lot of great football players in the high school systems in West Virginia, but there is a lot of great football players in this area for the University of Pittsburgh to take.
An area that many people have come over the years. You showed us the list of great quarterbacks that's well known. Good hitting on first down on the run by Jason Colson there, just for a yard and a half. Clint Session made the tackle along with Postel. Vince Krichunas in there. Vince, we heard from that soundbite earlier, talking about the clash of cultures and it's the Mines against the Mills. Vince Krichunas is a triple major, now in grad school. What a thoughtful, intelligent, entertaining young man. And a good football player as well. On that front, Marshall pumps, now comes back to the middle, complete to the 45 for a first down. Eddie Jackson, the catch, that little pump really helped open it up for the receiver.
That's what you have to try to replace Chris Henry with, is coming up with some guys who are going to be able to just make some big catches just for first downs. I mean, West Virginia is going to run the football to win this game, and tonight they need just enough from their passing game to be able to pick up some valuable first downs to keep drives alive and get back to their bread and butter, which is their running game.
From the 45, a little quick toss to Colson. He hurdles forward for 5. Josh Lay out of Aliquippa High School here in the Pittsburgh area made the tackle. Obviously, we talked about the backyard brawl and everything that's happened in sports, that incident as Jackson limps off the field, the incident in Detroit last week with the Pacers and Pistons, and then Clemson, South Carolina. You know, Rasheed Marshall a couple of years ago, when he was a young West Virginia quarterback, as he was walking back from the stadium past a tailgate, somebody dumped a beer on him, threw a beer at him. They were disappointed, didn't play well. Handoff here goes into the line, and
not somebody,
Williams has stopped.
But a West Virginia fan.
Right, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's the thing.
In Morgantown there.
Yeah.
On their own quarterback. And that does not say about all the West Virginia fans, but that one person in particular. Rasheed Marshall, then a sophomore. How did he handle it? He said to the person, "That really wasn't the nicest thing to do," and kept going. He understood. Wasn't the right thing to do. The person who did it was extraordinarily wrong. Hopefully that person was pointed out to authorities, but Rasheed Marshall handled it the right way. All the questions of if one of the pros should know how to handle it the right way, this kid did. Says all you need to know about the caliber of person the Mountaineer quarterback is. 3rd and 5, he steps up and throws a strike complete. First down and a gain of 16, hauled in by Charles Hales, another reserve quarterback.
Rasheed Marshall does something really good here, Kirk. He gets the play, he's watching down, but watch him step up right there. Ooh, Kirk, that was a beautiful play, and it shows perfect way to do it when you get outside pressure.
Yeah, he felt the pressure. He threw to the backup quarterback, Charles Hales, who knows how to find those pockets in the zones. And again, they pick up that valuable first down.
And KJ Harris takes the next carry and runs hard for 10 first down yards.
At one point also, that was a first of pass attempt on first and 10 after 19 straight rushes.
Now, this is something you got to ask any receiver in this kind of offense. Miguel Henderson, top of the screen, picks up a block, gets away a little bit with a hold, but that's okay. But at least he's willing to give it a try. Some receivers don't give it a try. When you run this kind of offense, you have to have receivers who are willing to give that kind of effort on the perimeter to open up these running lanes.
20th first down run of the night. Why not? Williams to the three. Going to be close to first and goal. Tez Morris came in for the free safety stop.
Well, this offensive line, we've talked about it throughout this football game. When you average 258 yards a game on the ground, you've got great backs, but there's also outstanding chemistry with the group up front. And when you have eight guys up in the box, you better rely on an offensive line that knows how to get things done up front.
Dan Moses, 76, the left guard, made a perfect double block on that play.
Toss, Williams tries to get to the outside. Session chased him down. Penalty marker comes in as well. It was a first down play. A lot of big penalties on the Mountaineers here in the third quarter. We'll find out who it's on in a second. Tom Thompson, the referee here tonight.
Personal foul on the offense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Still first down.
Maybe we won't find out who it's on.
Now that man wants to know who's on.
He probably found out. So it'll come back to the 18-yard line.
Rich is always pretty fired up, but as a former Mountaineer player, now the head coach of this program in a backyard brawl, I think he knows the meaning of this rivalry as well as anybody. Just look at his face.
So this is first and goal from the 18 after the third major penalty of this quarter. Marshall looking over to the sideline for some guidance.
Changing the play based on the coverage.
Check to this run for Williams, and it is stopped.
Rasheed Marshall, as Lee said, looks for confirmation over the sideline. He's changing the play right now. He's moving Pernell Williams. He's getting everything set up. Now look at Pittsburgh's defense. They know exactly by their scouting report. They realize that they can show him a look, and he might change the play, and then that's when they go to their defense, and that time, the cat and mouse game, the Pittsburgh defense won.
From the 17, Marshall. Pumping, nowhere to go except out of bounds. Panther defense has done a nice job down here in the red zone. All night they've done a good job in the red zone.
Paul Rhodes' defensive secondary that time really had good coverage downfield with all the West Virginia receivers, and that's why Marshall had to run the football. That was a very good defensive play by the entire secondary to blanket those receivers.
It is so difficult to defend Rasheed Marshall because when you put such effort to stop the receivers, he has the ability to get upfield and get away from that surge of the pass rush. And at that time, they contained him and forced him to the boundary.
Third and goal. The sideline says stay in the play. Pittsburgh rushes four. It's a little screen to KJ Harris. Pursued well. Brought down. This defense has been very good in the red zone. Thomas Smith made the play that time. Fourth down. From here, the field goal will be a 30-yard attempt. Remember, the last one was a low-line drive that was blocked by J.J. Horn.
Remember, West Virginia scored 69 points in the last two games against Pittsburgh with Rasheed Marshall. That means Paul Rhodes and his staff have done a tremendous job so far for Pittsburgh.
Different kicker, Andy Good, hasn't kicked all year. Kind of like a kicker whose last name is Good from 31 yards. Good.
Good is good.
Good.
Good, good.
That was a really big chancy call by the head football coach, Rich Rodriguez, to put a guy like that in the brawl.
Oh, not much of a choice what position you're to play when your last name's Good.
Yeah.
Woo! Mountaineers, up four.
It's Green Apple gone silver. Introducing Bacardi Silver Low Carb Green Apple Premium Malt Beverage. 4.5 grams of carbs and 94 calories, never tasted so good. Bacardi Silver, flavoring your night.
Come over, baby, whole lot of steak is going on. We faking steak stampede is going on.
Applebee's Steak Stampede.
Steak, baby, steak.
At CDW, we ship over 100,000 IT products to customers every day. So how can we do it even faster? One word, wormholes. I think it could really change things. It could take our shipping system to a whole new level. Now I just need to figure out the whole space-time continuum thing.
For the top brand IT products you need shipped out fast, count on CDW for the right technology right away.
By anchoring a more powerful 6-liter Power Stroke diesel engine to its frame, we gave the new Ford Super Duty more pulling power than any other pickup. Enough to lug up to 19,200 pounds. Don't get in its way. This is the next Ford Super Duty, built Ford tough.
Tonight's game available on ESPN HD thanks to Best Buy and Phillips. And checking the ESPN HD rundown, you'll have college football, Boise State, Nevada, as mentioned on Saturday. Chris and Tommy with NFL primetime on Sunday night before the Raiders and Broncos. With Mike, Joe, Paul, and Susie in Denver. I understand it's supposed to be cold and snowy out in Colorado. Well, what about Andy Good from Boardman, Ohio? Where is that, Governor?
That's Youngstown.
Youngstown area?
Valley.
Thank you.
Eastern Ohio there.
First ever kick in a pressure spot, and he knocked it through. 13-9, unreturnable kickoff, and a touchback. Was that Brad Cooper kicking off, the guy who just lost his place-kicking job? Well, this series, go back to 1970, 35-8, the Mountaineers were on top. Pittsburgh then adjusted at the half. They came out in the power eye and scored four touchdowns. Dave Haver in this touchdown, they go on top by one. West Virginia fans so angry after the game, they beat on the dressing room door going after Bobby Bowden. Look at this cheerleader.
That's interesting.
The Bobby Bowden.
The winningest coach in the history of major Division I football?
That's correct.
Nobody's immune, evidently.
From the 20, Tyler Palko with the handoff. Good forward move by Murphy. Strong run. He's going to push 100 yards here soon.
Can we go back to the technique there?
Look at that.
Not only the uni, but the back. What is that?
That might be before even my time.
What would the chief give us on that? She's our official cheerleading consultant.
Get her on the horn real quick. I don't know. Chief would give that, say, old school, probably.
Old school. 16 carries, 96 yards now for Murphy here on the night. Yeah, and he'll get the first down and get right up against 100 yards for this junior out of Akron, Ohio.
You know, when we looked at the tapes of Pittsburgh, we were impressed with Gill and Mike Cuis, the tight ends. They haven't caught a single pass, yet they were the guys that helped beat Notre Dame. I mean, Mike Cuis had two touchdown passes against Notre Dame, hadn't called his name yet. Gill had 9 starts, great play against Notre Dame, hadn't called his name. Pittsburgh needs to find a way to get the ball to those tight ends somehow.
Eric Gill has 22 grabs on the year, third on this team. Also, Joe Del Sardo, their other wide receiver, he has been shut out thus far tonight. they're having to do it on the ground. And Murphy over 100 yards here. You mentioned Joe Del Sarto, who has 35 catches on the year, a walk-on who's earned a scholarship, looking for his first grab of the night, but he is our Applebee's hometown hero. He found out in front of everyone after a Friday practice at the start of the season. He was no longer a walk-on. He was going to be a scholarship player. He had asked for a scholarship after the inter-squad game, the blue-gold game in the spring. Didn't get one, but his mom and his aunt Debbie, said, hang in there. There's a plan for you. Stick with it. He got the scholarship and didn't have to pay the $16,000 in tuition and expenses this year. Palco, pressure from behind, brought down by Jason Hardy. A returning starter out of San Mateo, California. His third sack of the season.
That was excellent average, excellent coverage downfield, but most important, the coverage caused Palco to come down and run it. Kirk, take this guy, Hardy. What a nice effort on his part, huh?
Again, it goes back to the different tracks. Offensive line does the job well enough, but the coverage you talked about, Lee, downfield, Paco's looking down into some coverage. I talked about it earlier, outside of Greg Lee. You talked about the tight ends, but nobody can get away from the athletic ability of West Virginia's defense other than Greg Lee.
They've got to find a tight end.
Third and 13. In trouble again. Up for grabs and dropped. Nearly brought in by Lee. Would have been enough for a first down. Kevin McClee and Jay Henry had the pressure on Palco.
They're giving him so many different looks. It's confusing Palco. He threw it up there. Lee should have made the catch, but realistically, they're very fortunate to even have an opportunity there to make that catch. The offensive line that time, by the time Palco hit his fifth step, they had allowed two guys to come right through, and it just goes back to the way that 3-3-5 is confusing the Pittsburgh pass protection.
Remember, it's the first time they've seen it this year.
Jones on the run from the 27, works the sideline and steps out at the 37. Just a net of 33 yards there. It is a rivalry game. Tyler Palco's first experience. It's one that's going to last for a couple of days.
Coming up on SportsCenter after the game, Peyton's incredible touchdown pace continues. How it compares to Marino's run in 84, does it compare to McGuire's run at 61? And is he the best quarterback ever? SportsCenter after the backyard brawl.
ESPN Original Entertainment presents
NASCAR's gotta have talent and your magic on the asphalt.
Barry Pepper stars as Dale Earnhardt 3. Premieres Saturday, December 11th, 9 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
Carp Auto, Buick, Saab, and Volvo. For three generations, the Carp family has made every Carp customer feel like part of the family. Carp is your auto authority, where excellence in all things is a matter of pride. The cars we sell at Carp are the safest on the road, and it's a safe bet. You won't find a better buying experience than at Carp Auto. Great price is just the beginning.
Because we're your auto authority, Carp.
Sunrise Highway, Rockville Center.
Now playing, a revolution in resolution. ESPN HD, the big picture in sports. Visually stunning and wildly enhanced clarity on the screen like you've never seen. Now playing.
Available on IO Digital Cable Service. From Cablevision, call 1-866-20-DIGITAL.
ESPN's College Football Primetime is presented by Hitachi, the ultimate television viewing experience, and in part by the next Ford Super Duty. Tougher, stronger, smarter.
Hope you've enjoyed a very happy Thanksgiving with your family, friends, and loved ones. Glad that you've invited us into your home to wrap up this Thanksgiving 2004. the Backyard Brawl, 97th playing of this West Virginia-Pittsburgh rivalry. Two schools separated by 70 miles. Rasheed Marshall, first down pass, incomplete. Neither team has been able to consistently move the ball with a good defensive effort here tonight. Tyrone Gilliard, a three-year starter, one of the two West Virginians playing for Pittsburgh, was on the coverage there.
West Virginia now has 22 runs on first and 10. And that was their second pass attempt on first and 10. And it was there. I mean, when you run the ball that often on first and 10, the defense is obviously going to put everybody up tight to stop another run attempt.
Second and 10. Marshall keeps it and throws it. Solid arm. Rashawn Bolden made his first catch of the year. It's 18 yards, but there's a penalty marker down back where it was thrown. And another personal foul. And Rich Rodriguez is steamed.
Personal foul. 65 offense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Second down.
Jeremy Sheffy is the right guard.
That's a shame, not only because it's going to back West Virginia back, but how pretty was the play action there by Rasheed Marshall. It just reminded me of this afternoon watching Peyton Manning. You talk about a technician, and I know we talk about it every week with Peyton Manning, but just sitting back and watching it, how about the ball fakes? That entire offense right now looks, they play like a video game. It's automatic every time they get the ball.
That was some show.
Oh my gosh.
After the fourth major penalty of the quarter, Marshall takes off, gets back to the 34, shy of the original line, and we'll have third and long coming up inside of two, third quarter minutes left.
Speaking of Peyton Manning, he's going after that record of Dan Marino's. To me, that's the only record I thought to compare to Joe DiMaggio's 56-game hitting streak that would maybe never be broken. I mean, that's a lot of touchdown passes in 1 year, like DiMaggio's 56-game hitting streak.
Former Pittsburgh Panther Dan Marino for the NFL record, 48 touchdown passes back in 84. Here, third and 14, they need to get to midfield. Marshall, pocket collapse, intercepted. H.B. Blades, the son of former Detroit Lion Benny Blades.
It's one of the few mistakes you're going to see Rasheed Marshall make, and it's because he stared down his receiver. Blades read his eyes the entire way. He dropped back right here. He's going to just drop back, and his eyes are locked in to Rasheed Marshall. Rasheed Marshall comes off the fake. He's looking right to his man. He gets some pressure off to his right, but Blades just sunk back into the zone right in between the quarterback and the receiver.
Thomas Smith caused that by putting his face right in old Marshall's face.
Palco wanted to go to Murphy the back. He was covered. Tyler's in trouble. Just throws it away. It crossed the line of scrimmage, so it was not intentional grounding. Here's Jill with more on H.B. Blades.
Well, H.B. decided he wanted to make his mark elsewhere. He comes from a great bloodline of unbelievable football players down in Miami. I'll try to not take that too personal since I went to Miami, but he's looking good in that Pitt uniform, and he's making his mark, guys.
Yeah, H.B., of course, not just the son of Benny Blades, but also the nephew of Brian and Al Blades. Great Canes who went on to the NFL. Second and 10. Come back to Murphy. Only his ability to bounce off the first hit able to avoid a negative play there. We'll have third and about 5.5 coming up.
47 to Dino.
If Greg Lee isn't going to make the catch, The only other option at this point that Tyler Palko has, guys who can get open, are the running backs. The tight ends can't get off of the coverage. The other receivers can't get off of the coverage. So right now, Palko's dropping back, and it's either Greg Lee, who's going to be at the top of the screen, or a running back slipping out of the backfield because nobody else can get open.
They've got to get the ball to Eric Gill. If Notre Dame couldn't cover him, why should West Virginia? Come on, get it to him now.
Third and seventh throw for Del Sardo was on the turf. Ruled incomplete. And it will be fourth down.
Watch Eric Gill. If they show the middle of the field, number 45, you can maybe not see it. You'll the right-hand side of the picture. Kirk, I promise you, he was wide open in the middle of the field. He never even looked at him. Never looked, Mike.
Well, that time Del Sardo actually made a move here to the outside.
Here's what? Look at, there's my man. Look at him. Jeez.
Palko's 8 of 26. That looked very close to a catch,
sure
too,
did.
By the way. It looked like Del Sardo's arms were scooping under it. In any case, Pittsburgh unable to capitalize on the first West Virginia turnover. Russell does a beautiful job hitting them inside the 10. We had a very well-executed special teams play. Nice job by Gressel, kicking it inside the 20 and puts it out of bounds at the 3. Long field for the Mountaineers. Let me remind you that this Thanksgiving weekend continues on ABC Sports tomorrow in Lincoln, Colorado against Nebraska. The Buffs needing to win to keep their hopes for the Big 12 North Championship alive. Nebraska trying to avoid a losing season and get to a bowl game. And a very important game with Texas A&M taking on Texas with bowl implications Friday on ABC. Huge game in Austin. The final snap of this third quarter. Cornell Williams to the 5. We've exchanged field goals in the third. Much lower scoring game than expected. But it's tight, it's close. Fourth quarter. Somebody keeps BCS hopes alive in the final 15 minutes.
Sunday NFL Countdown presented by Old Spice, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
Performance and handling like a car. All-wheel drive capability like an SUV. The totally new Ford Freestyle. One vehicle. Endless possibilities. Ford, built for the road ahead.
This holiday season, give that special someone on your list something they can't wait to use. Grab all your gifts and a tree to put them under. You can at the Home Depot. Starting this Friday, this straight line laser level is half off at just $9.96. And this Ryobi 7.2 volt cordless drill is an incredible $9.97. Nobody has more know-how to help make your holiday dollars work harder. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
K-Swiss. A classic remix.
Put your spin on it.
New colors.
For right now.
Here's the new spin.
Turn it up.
Keep it smooth.
K-Swiss Classics.
This is my group.
Put your spin on
it. A different vibe.
A new beat. Spin it like this.
Put your spin on it.
I keep it classic.
My K-Swiss.
Put your spin on it.
K-Swiss.
The Sharp Aquas Liquid Crystal Television. Truer color is the key.
Introducing the Canon Rebel T2. A sophisticated yet easy to use SLR that'll help you take extraordinary photographs. The new Canon T2. Once a rebel, always a rebel.
Men don't like to shave. They'd rather light their shorts on fire or eat dirt. Easy, fellas. Nivea soothes the pain of shaving. With moisturizers and vitamins, Nivea for Men Aftershave Balm soothes and improves. Nivea for Men. More evolved skincare.
And off we go to the fourth quarter. Here on College Football Primetime, presented by Cooper Tires. Mountaineers 13, Panthers 9. We say happy Thanksgiving to our entire ESPN crew, our great Thursday night crew, been on the road with us here for so many years. Would rather be with no other group.
Absolutely.
We have to come to work.
Best group in the business.
Yeah, thank you, folks. Really enjoyed Thanksgiving together last night. Here's a run for Pernell Williams. Gets away from that hit at the 9 and bumps it out past the 11-yard line. So we'll have third and short coming up, and it's a very cold night out there. Everyone dealing with the conditions as well. Game time temperature was about 29 at kickoff. It's come down a bit, but feels about as cold as it was at kickoff because of the wind dying down. Still 52,641 hardy Western Pennsylvanians and West Virginians on hand. Third and a yard. Williams is stopped. Ran right into Vince Fortunis. And the Mountaineers will have to punt.
Vince Fortunis, 35 straight starts, 6'4", 290 pounds. And watch him on the left side of the picture, just stuff it right there. And gets, they call that shedding the blocker, which means he controls the, neutralizes the offensive guard, then sheds him and makes a tackle. That was a major league play by Chris Humus.
Phil Brady to kick. What a time it would be for Pittsburgh to get its first big kick return of the year. Taken by the upback. A chance here from the 39. Still on his feet to the 20-yard line. So Revis, the cornerback, has a 19-yard return. In there is the upback, not expected to be the one to get his hands on it. A big return.
Darrell Revis, another one of the true freshmen in college football, making an impact this year. Comes up, not only making a catch, but also you can see the athletic ability of a cover corner and what he can do when he fields a punt that's short. He didn't just look to get down. He was looking to score.
That was their longest true punt return of the year. Statistically, they had one longer, but it was on a messed up punt from the other side. From the 20, Murphy lost his footing and lost a yard. There were four high school football playoff games in here, in addition to the Panthers and Steelers playing their home game. There's a lot of seed down in all these areas where you see brown. And as Rich Rodriguez said, as we were down the field before the game, I don't know if anybody thinks this seed's going to grow, but it's not going to grow. The growing season is gone here in Pittsburgh.
Defensive coordinator Jeff Castile has called an excellent game by putting pressure from West Virginia on Palco. I think he should blitz him right now. There they come. See him coming up the middle?
It's picked up. Palco up top for Del Sordo. Incomplete. Intended for Joe. The defensive coordinator urging his troops on before they came back out on the field.
What it is dropping your pads, playing with your knees, man, getting your hands on people coming off the box. That's what's going to do it.
Boy, he just called Adam Leonard and Scott Jerko. Both came up the middle. Boy, that nice pressure. That was a good call by Castile.
A man who was raised a West Virginia fan.
The way they're covering on the outside, it makes a lot of sense to bring as many as you can.
Third and 11, Palco trying to make something big happen. Almost took him out of field goal range. Lucky to get rid of it. And incomplete. West Virginia team is looking for intentional grounding. There was a receiver right over there. It was high. He couldn't bring it in, but it was over an ineligible receiver's head. Once again, Jay Henry and Kevin McClee had coverage. But Palco, by making that play, keeps him in field goal range.
That's called rumbling, fumbling, stumbling for your life there. That's every ounce of energy to get it to the outside, of that tackle, to be able to throw that football downfield out of bounds.
Josh Cummings has made three field goals tonight. This is a 40-yard attempt. He's hit big kicks all year. West Virginia started coming. Pittsburgh then flinched. And will it be a 5-yard longer attempt?
The defensive men can fake it coming across. The offensive men just can't move at all.
Offside.
Oh, wait.
Rich Rodriguez is saying that the deep snapper, Mike McGlynn, is flinching with the ball.
Worst part about it is Cummings, he hit the kick. He made the kick.
Now he gets to try it from 5 yards closer.
It's a muddy area there where he's kicking it from this time. Maybe a little bit more muddy?
It is a little bit.
Whole field's nasty.
The punter, Gressel, is the holder. Fading right, and he missed it. How bizarre. You make the field goal, get the penalty, the offside penalty, and miss from 5 yards closer. So it remains a 4-point game. But when we come back, guys, chance to talk about the top five. Did they change at all from last we saw each other in Salt Lake City?
My friends did, but mine had good weekend.
Good practice. Good practice habits. Week. Practice is
ate
important.
A lot of turkey. They're still number one.
Special delivery, ladies.
Well, look who's here.
Got your fresh beer right here.
What do you got?
I got intentional. I got intentional taste mask. All American brewed beers are fresh. This guy's hiding something.
Yep.
Illegal use of the hand truck. Distributing beer with less taste.
Place it with Miller Lite.
More taste.
Half the carbs.
You can't flag the king.
Right.
Okay, we got multiple penalties on Dan.
Intentional Miller.
Taste mask.
Good call.
Illegal use of the hand truck.
On Tuesday, the castaways of the Rio Gilligan's Island will meet their match, literally.
Seven other castaways come walking into our camp.
You've got to be kidding me.
Be there, as one of TV's most beloved sitcoms is now one of the most anticipated new reality series of the season. And the competition to be rescued from the island gets ugly.
There she is, the Wicked Witch of the West.
Give it a rest.
It's not going to be such a friendly little hut.
The Rio Gilligan's Island premieres Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on TBS.
It's the Fajita Grilled Stuffed Burrito from Taco Bell. Loaded with authentic carne asada steak and grilled fajita vegetables. All wrapped in a flour tortilla and grilled to go.
Ooh, fajitas.
For sizzling fajita taste, think outside the bun.
At Fred Meyer Jewelers and Lippmann Jewelers, these dazzling 1-carat total weight diamond earrings are on sale for $9.99. But for 3 days only, save an additional $400 and pay only $5.99. At Fred Meyer Jewelers and Lippmann Jewelers.
This is titanium. Strong, long-lasting, durable. And only Remington brings it to you in the all-new titanium shaving system. Designed for closeness, comfort, and to clean itself automatically. Any way you slice it, it's extraordinary. Shave after shave. Remington Titanium. It could just make all other shavers obsolete. And for her, the Remington Smooth and Silky, America's number one women's brand.
Whoever wins here tonight will be watching Saturday on ABC as Syracuse visits Boston College with its backup quarterback. The Eagles, with a win, would get the BCS bid. If they lose, the winner tonight will be in position to get it. It's been a great defensive effort on both sides in this rivalry game. Marshall, a first down run. Another first down across the 32-yard line. Now to the 34, a gain of 14 for the Pittsburgh Native. Well, we advertised the top fives. Did they change at all based on who ate the most Thanksgiving turkey?
No, my heaven. Southern California, Auburn, Oklahoma, Utah, and Cal. Those are my five.
I have USC. I've moved Oklahoma back to two. I have Auburn at three, Cal at four, and Utah at five. Kind of came, you know, besides good practice habits this week these teams, I think it comes down to me, I'm so tired of talking about strength of schedule and who plays in what conference and where do these things all, who does it favor, who does it not, who are the best teams? Who are the best teams that we've seen week in and week out? In my opinion, USC has has the best team, Oklahoma the second best, and Auburn the third best.
I think Auburn is better for what I've seen.
Yeah.
When I saw them beat that Georgia team, they look better than Oklahoma that beat Oklahoma State.
Motion flag here on the Mountaineers. Excuse me.
Prior to the snap, false start. 89 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
It is kind of the silliness of the system, and we've talked about this for years, but we're going to be in a position where we could have 5 unbeaten teams, something we haven't had in a quarter century in college football, and we're only 5 games away from that happening.
I'll give you silliness. Imagine tonight if Pittsburgh upsets West Virginia and Syracuse knocks off Boston College. Chances are Pittsburgh will be going to the BCS, and teams like Texas and California are sitting there trying to state their case to even get in to the BCS. That's crazy.
From the 29, it is now first and 15. Just a 1-yard gain on the run with players grabbing for the ball, but Colson was down there. The argument would be somebody from the NFC is going to get to the Super Bowl. Somebody at 8-8 or 9-7 who wins a division in the NFC is going to get to the NFC playoffs when other deserving teams in the AFC won't. Win your division and you get in. That would be the counter to the argument. I'm going to say I disagree with you.
Okay, I was going to say, you're saying that maybe a team that's 8-8 or 9-7 gets to the Super Bowl, which means they got hot into the postseason and
right,
got to the Super Bowl.
With you.
And in college football, obviously, we don't have that. So what has Cal done wrong if they finish off their season with a win against Southern Miss? It's a slam dunk. You know, they should be in a Rose Bowl. They should be in the BCS, case closed. They shouldn't even have to worry about what Texas does against Texas A&M or what Boise might do. They should finish their season off and pack their bags for Pasadena.
Claremont made the play there. They're having in Rasheed Marshall left. Third and long coming up.
The thing that I'm most upset is Oklahoma and Auburn, neither one of them should not have a chance to play for the national
right.
Of
course.
Because we've watched them. They're very good football teams, and so is USC. But it happens once in a while.
Third and 17 for the Mountaineers. They need to get to the 44. Marshall out of the pocket where he's dangerous, on the move, eluding tacklers, but pushed out of bounds. 4 yards shy of a first down. So with 11:01 left, it'll be a punt back to the Panthers.
I cannot even begin to tell you how impressive Pitt has been tonight in containing Rasheed Marshall. All year long, we've talked about his acceleration upfield when he gets into that shotgun. And I know he leads the Mountaineers tonight in rushing with 88 yards on 12 carries. But for the most part, he hasn't come up with those big plays to keep drives alive. And Paul Rose's group on defense, Pittsburgh's defense, has done a nice job of containing him.
If it wasn't for Rasheed Marshall, I don't think West Virginia would have a first down. That guy is really good.
Phil Brady rolls, runs a fake, and dives for the first down. He was lined up 12 yards behind the line of scrimmage, not the normal 15 yards. Kind of looked weird, but those 3 yards may have been the difference and could have been a tip.
Bobby Bowden at West Virginia.
What a call.
The thing is the wheels on this guy. I mean, this is a punter. I mean, he's turning the corner here with some speed. Pretty good athlete. Look at this. Of course, the blocks are there, but he knows exactly where he has to get. Go for that first down.
What a
good
call
speed
by
for a punter.
Oh, Brady, who is taking a flag here on first down. West Virginia's really been flagged a lot here in this second half.
Prior to the snap, false start, 58 offense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Brady, who has caught the ire of his head coach more than a few times tonight and this season. Think back to that Wednesday night game against Connecticut. Poor Brady, he was just running to the other side of the bench. Comes up with a huge play, and as you said, great runner-like awareness of where he had to get to, diving for the first down.
A little speed.
7 of those penalties and 71 of those penalty yards against West Virginia coming here in the second half. Design run, Marshall lost his footing and lost a couple of yards. Vince Krutunas again with the play.
Krutunas might be, and in 9 years or 10 years, I've been at ESPN, my favorite guy to sit down and talk to. Three-time academic all-time?
Two, working on three.
This year will be his third time to receive that honor. to sit down and talk to him. Very insightful, very intelligent, very savvy football player, and he gives you everything that he has on every snap.
He reminds me of Mike Golick. Not Mike's playing ability, but gregarious nature. Down the middle, intercepted at the 27-yard line by Darrell Revis. And a good punt return, comes up with the interception here. Second time the Mountaineers have turned it over here in the second half.
Well, Revis is a true freshman. Kirk mentioned it before. I like this nice position, Kirk, but this is closing speed right there. But watch the fact that the ball was thrown in front of the receiver, but he had the ability to catch it, Kirk. Nice play.
I continue to be amazed every week to see true freshmen walk into big-time college football and not only make an impact, but make big plays. Paul Rhodes, the defensive coordinator, said, "He's the best I've ever been around at this age." Very mature for a young man to walk into this kind of conference and this kind of game and make a play.
He's from Aliquippa, Pennsylvania. Some great football players from Aliquippa.
Pittsburgh called this timeout. Boy, you really don't want to waste timeouts. I think they've wasted two here this half.
I don't know what I was thinking.
I tried to tell you, genius.
I can't believe I'm in this situation. We're not having fun anymore.
I'm feeling your pain.
I don't know what to do.
Hey, look at me. We all make mistakes.
I told you about the tires, huh?
Yeah. You should have gotten Cooper.
Buying tires is a big decision. Next time, get everything you want. Cooper Tires. Don't give up a thing.
Tiger Woods, Annika Sorenstam, Fred Couples, Adam Scott, an ABC Sports Thanksgiving weekend tradition. The Maryland Skins Game, Saturday and Sunday on ABC.
So, my gnome nappers, it seems our romantic getaway is coming to an end. Do thank Travelocity for me. Ah, that's the spirit, chap. Give her a kiss. Now, that's enough. You're not invisible, you know. Oh, my goodness. Hello? Is this Travelocity? We're going to need a later flight. Ah! A much later flight.
Change of plans? 24/7 customer service. Book with Travelocity, and you'll never roam alone.
Ignoring you. Ignoring you.
$120.90.
I'll just put it on the credit card.
But those rates.
Put it on our Capital One Prime Lock card.
Introducing the new Capital One Prime Lock card. It's set at prime so you never have to worry about your interest rate again. Check your mailbox for details.
What's in your wallet?
Our producers, Bo Garrett, our director, Mike Schwab, leading our ESPN crew. Glad to have you with us here on Thanksgiving night. Scott Van Pelt and Susie Culver standing by for SportsCenter. A lot more to do, and we will make a holiday appearance on ESPN News with the much-anticipated post-game extra.
Scotty, recover from last Thursday?
I don't know.
At Maryland performance?
First down run for Tim Murphy. Over 100 yards rushing tonight and gains about four on that carry. Tyler Palko, the sophomore quarterback from West Allegheny High School here in the Pittsburgh area, had really emerged over the last 3 games, highlighting those 3 games, a record 5 touchdowns at Notre Dame. Never happened in South Bend against the Irish. Well, tonight, here in the backyard brawl, as this rivalry is known, 8 for 28 passing. Credit much of it to this 3-3-5 defense that the Mountaineers play. Play action, a little trickeration. Darryl Strong unable to get back to the original line of scrimmage. A play that loses 4. Strong from Florida tried to stop and cut.
Not on this field. It's a little trickeration here. They try to set it up, but look at West Virginia sitting back. Adai's back there. Pac-Man Jones sitting back there waiting. Anthony Mims. And they had 3 defenders. Even if he would have been able to settle down and get his feet planted, he would have thrown into a triple coverage downfield.
Maybe the best thing that happened on that play.
Right.
Officially, they credit about at the 30, so it's 3rd and about 7.5. Palko to the
Sorry.
Caught by Eric.
Yay!
For a first down.
The guy beat Notre Dame. It's the first time they throw the ball to him. Please already. 6'5", 270. Watch Eric Gill. Comes. He's been doing this all day, ladies and gentlemen. They finally threw it to him. Kirk?
Yep, you're right. Six catches, 89 yards, and of course the big catch against the Irish where he pulled it, against the Irish, 36 yards downfield for eventually the game-winning field goal.
Happy now, Coach, huh?
Well, he haven't even looked at him the whole game. I'm sorry.
First and 10 from the 40 here is play action. They come right at Palco. He's got to get rid of it. It's incomplete. Intended for his sophomore receiver, Del Sardo.
I learned one time, anytime you got a quarterback getting out of pressure, the number one receiver to throw it to is the tight end. You know why? This is really simple. He's the closest guy to you. And he can run option routes, and you throw the ball. That pass right there has to go 25 yards.
Right.
The other one has to go 10, and you get 15 yards. You know that. It just get the guy the quickest you can get to him.
Not to mention the way they're blitzing their linebackers. Yeah. There's a nice vacancy right there in the middle of the field.
Here is second and 10, a screen to Raymond Kirkley. He's been quiet tonight, and he's got half the West Virginia defense. Throwing him down. 8-2, third and 8 coming up.
What it really comes down to against this 3-3-5 is Pittsburgh just doesn't have the playmakers. I mean, Gill can make a catch for 8 or 10 yards. Yeah. Greg Lee's the only guy that can get downfield. It's not only Larry Fitzgerald that's missing from this offense from a year ago. They've lost a lot of their playmakers on the outside from a year ago.
Prince L. Brockenborough, one of their wide receivers, multiple knee injuries. Terrell Allen tore a ligament against Texas A&M, re-entered that in the spring, so the guys who were counted on to be the top receivers never saw the field this year. Third and 8, Palco down the middle. Is it caught by Lee? Nobody said no, so I guess it's yes. Complete. First down at the 43-yard line, a gain of 15 for Greg Lee.
Looks like that ball went through, and it's probably a better angle. Looks like it gets to the ground. You know what, though, as a receiver, he did a nice job of turning and then coming up, saying, here we go, first down.
Where's the Big Ten replay when we need it?
I bet you guys you're going to see replay in the BCS games. I'm hearing whispers about that. Palco, play action, first and 10. Underneath, incomplete. Tim Murphy was not ready to catch the ball. Here's Jill with more on the Pittsburgh quarterback.
Well, it was a former Pittsburgh quarterback, Pete Gonzalez, who first recognized the talent of Tyler Palco. Back when he was in eighth grade, he told Coach Harris, you've got to check this guy out. He's amazing. He's the future for a quarterback. And guys, it's fourth quarter drives where you can really see the talent of a leader at that quarterback position. We'll see what happens.
Boy, Pete Gonzalez, Jill, is a gutsy quarterback. Even remember guys back in the old stadium up on campus, up on the hill there? We saw Pete hit some great games.
Really helped get Walt Harris started to get a lot of other great recruits to come to Pittsburgh.
Second and 10, Palco 5 options, comes to Murphy. May one man miss, and did a nice second effort job to get into a third short situation. Jay Henry made the tackle, makes friends with your offensive coordinator, much rather call third and medium than third and 7 or 8. Kind of running out of drives here. Maybe this one and one more if the Panthers are lucky. Scott Van Pelt and Susie Caldwell standing by. They'll have SportsCenter, all the Thanksgiving football reaction. The Colts dominance in Detroit. The Cowboys winning at home over the Bears. Third and 5. Passes caught by Lee to the 23. About 17 things happened on that play. Jerko, the blitzing linebacker, jumped in the air. The coverage downfield. It got through.
Jerko's going to come right over the top. What? Whoop! Now, Kirk, you saw he threw the ball to Gill, and Lee caught it. You're not going to believe that.
He threw it to Gill, Gill got held and slowed down by a dime, and it comes right to Lee. Lee made a nice move off of Pac-Man Jones to pick up a few more yards.
That was my mistake. It was Mike Lorello bringing the pressure. 23, okay. Not 33.
But let me tell you something. That was a pass right to Gill. Yo, what a coach.
Lee, 7 catches, 116 yards. Looking his way again on the outcut. Incomplete. And while that looks like it wasn't a sharp play, we saw him slip coming out of the break. It's very hard for these guys to hit these timing routes here tonight. officially 117 yards. Fifth time over a C-note for the sophomore out of Florida.
Greg Lee has really matured this year. Only a sophomore in the mic, he said. Last 2 weeks against Syracuse and Notre Dame, 14 catches for 283 yards. They said he's learned how to practice. He's matured, and he all of a sudden realized it's not just showing up and playing on Saturday, or in this case, Thursday night.
Second and 10 from the 23. More play action. Palko off to the races. They'll get about 5 yards. Down at about the 18, third down coming up. Jill, how does that feel?
It's not looking good, guys. It was pretty torn up to start the game, but now in the middle of the hashes, it's all mud, and you're right, they're losing their footing. And the helpers keep bringing out these little grates for them to clear out their cleat so they can get better footing. But on these routes, these guys really need to focus so they can keep their footing and make these plays.
One slip could be the difference in making the BCS or not.
That's an advantage for the offense. The defense has to respond to which way the offense is trying to make their move for the in a running route.
Third and 5, West Virginia. A lot of players standing up. Who's coming? Who's covering? Palko underneath. It is caught at the 10. A first down for who else? Greg Lee's 8th catch of the night, 53rd on the season.
This is football 101. It's 3rd and 6. You run the route to 7 or 8 yards, and you just turn back to the quarterback. And Greg Lee makes a heck of a catch. One thing that Greg Lee has, outstanding hands. Every time he makes a catch, he's not using his pads. He's putting his hands out to make the catch.
And Palko put that ball, the only spot that anybody could catch it would be right down there low. That was a nice pass by Palko to a perfect spot for Lee.
First and goal. Panthers haven't scored a touchdown yet tonight. Looked like a throw from Kirkley to the tight end. Pass interference flag coming. Eric Gill had 4 players with him.
My God.
None of them turned to look at the ball.
This is the second, isn't on this drive, it's the second time they've tried the one time it was with the receiver, and now with the running back. And both times, West Virginia sitting back there with 4 defenders waiting for the throw.
10. Penalty was in the end zone. The ball will be placed at the 2-yard line.
Picked up the flag.
Jill just talked about the field conditions. Watch how much it slows Murphy down. I mean, he's being so careful, and he takes such time there to throw the football that it gave the defense plenty of time to get back.
It was Tim Murphy who threw it. Justin Acerno, the fullback, in ahead of Murphy. Panthers for the lead. Palko looking to throw. Incomplete. Intended for Lee.
Jeff Castillo, as a defensive coordinator, has a very disciplined defense. I mean, there's some things that you would expect, the aggression of the defense to fly up to take away the option and for the receiver to be all alone. But that time, Pac-Man Jones just sat back there and was right in where he needed to be, forced the quarterback, Tyler Palko, to throw it away.
Pittsburgh has scored 83% of the time to get into the red zone. I question that call because now they really put themselves under pressure.
Palko, keeping, scoring! Touchdown, Pittsburgh! Has had some very, very good quarterbacks in his college and NFL days. Yeah, I think he really likes being around Tyler Palko, what he brings to the team. 2-point lead, every kick is huge. Extra point try for Josh Cummins. Made them all year. Makes this one as well. 4:06 remaining. Tyler Palko led a great comeback in South Bend last week. It was not pretty, but it was a great Pittsburgh gutsy, hard-nosed 14 play. Go ahead, touchdown drive.
Coming up on SportsCenter after the game, Peyton's incredible touchdown pace continues. How it compares to Marino's run in 84. Does it compare to McGuire's run at 61? And is he the best quarterback ever? SportsCenter after the backyard brawl.
Home is where the hoop is with the ESPN Full Court College Basketball pay-per-view package. Bring more than 450 of the best games right into your home each week all season long. To order, call your local cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
Looking for the perfect gift that'll brighten everyone's holiday? Just head around the corner for our gift card from Applebee's.
Eating good in the neighborhood.
It's not your job.
It's not your lipstick. It's not your hair.
It's your watch that tells most about who you are. The Couture Collection by Seiko. The heart of a sports watch, the soul of a fashion watch.
Some people believe there's a carpentry gene, and I think I got it. Hanging things, I'm a little hit or miss on. But with the Black & Decker Bullseye, it's foolproof. I just find a stud, hang it on the wall, and it self-levels. Gives you a straight line every time.
The Bullseye from Black & Decker.
It's low carb to the core. Introducing Bacardi Silver Low Carb Green Apple Premium Malt Beverage. 4.5 grams of carbs and 94 calories, never tasting so good. Bacardi Silver. Flavor your night.
ESPN's College Football Primetime is presented by Cooper Tires. Confidence, performance, mileage, don't give up a thing. And in part by Allstate. Are you in good hands?
Well, the joint is jumping to stay warm and to stay fired up. This Pittsburgh sideline has been electric during the break. 4:06 left. They finally score a touchdown on the 70th snap tonight for the Panthers and take a three-point lead. Adam Gressel, the punter, kicks off, trying to keep it out of the hands of Pac-Man Jones. It slowly gets to the return man from the 11. Tries to get to the outside. No can do. Spilled at the 25 by Mike Phillips. Take you back to the touchdown, Kirk.
That was a nice block by the fullback. And then also over here, watch to the right. The guy that Lee's been talking about, not only trying to catch it, but blocking. Fullback Campbell right there. And there's Gill, 270 pounds, going up against 205 pounds. Lorello just created a seal block to the outside. And the quarterback ducked right underneath. His pitch man went the other way. So it was either Palko or nobody. And Palko took it in for a touchdown.
I'm not so sure that wasn't a design play to keep Palko in there running. Nice call by Walt Harris down the goal line.
Who calls all the Pittsburgh plays? Rasheed Marshall from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, from the 26. Gain of one. Told you at the top, Marshall, unrecruited by Pittsburgh as a quarterback. 40 tickets for this game. So many friends and neighbors and family here tonight. It's a West Virginia team that Marshall's trying to lead without its best receiver, Chris Henry. Trying to avoid back-to-back season-ending losses. The preseason pick in the Big East could be out of the championship chase if they don't score the next 3.5. Option. Haven't seen much of that tonight. Pittsburgh ready for it. Thomas Smith. HB Blades over there, 3rd and 6 coming up.
But they are in 4-down territory. They cannot afford to punt the ball with 3 minutes to go. They've got to go for it if they don't make it here.
Three timeouts left. The one thing I'll say is this is where, as a quarterback, your security blanket on 3rd down with the game on the line is Chris Henry. And he's not having him really hurts Rasheed Marshall.
Suspended for violating team rules. Back home in Morgantown, watching 3rd and 6. Marshall directing, threw it on the run, incomplete. could not find a receiver to come back and help him make a play. Let's see what Rich Rodriguez will do here on fourth down.
So this is where you miss Henry, and it's just you have a quarterback right now that just doesn't feel comfortable. Not only, and I know he likes to run, but watch, look at the guy he wants to throw the ball to. Hales has turned to block. Hales has turned to block downfield instead of trying to turn around and make a big catch.
Did you see K.J. Harris do the old Matador move? That's why he was in his face. I agree with the call. Win or lose, Rich Rodriguez, I think, is making the right call right here.
Could be the Mountaineer season here. Marshall, complete to the 45-yard line to Joe Hunter, who has zero catches on the season. 15 right there.
That was a great call by Rich Rodriguez, but it was also a wonderful throw by Wallace, but also Marshall, but also Tim Brown, the center, called the automatic line block, and Kirk, it was perfect. That was a great play by
you. You're back in your hometown. It's fourth down.
That's
the game's
it.
On the line. The crowd is going crazy, and you throw it to a guy who doesn't have a catch on the whole year.
Who was a defensive back at the start of preseason camp.
Wow.
The 45. This one's incomplete. Intended for Eddie Jackson.
If that doesn't illustrate Rasheed Marshall's career, I don't know what else could. That play, fourth down, makes a great throw. West Virginia, or Pittsburgh's defense didn't even cover Hunter. They figured he's not in the mix here.
Who's
that guy?
I wish you could have seen Tim Brown, the center, calling a slide protection, which means everybody going one way is a perfect pick block up front. It's a great play by Tim Brown, the center.
Second and 10. K.J. Harris, only available receiver. Using the sideline, he is taken out of bounds at midfield. We'll have third and about six coming up here at exactly the two-minute mark. Mountaineers full complement of timeouts left.
If there's one thing good about the spread offense, it's now. I mean, they don't have to go to any kind of a special. They know.
This is it.
This is it.
This is what they do.
They do this all the time.
Last play, they brought Pac-Man Jones, the corner, who leads the Mountaineers in defense and tackles out of the field to play a little receiver, which they've done. They've sprinkled him in throughout most of the year.
Flag down for offside. Free play. Marshall comes down a yard and a half shy of the first down, but the flag is going to make it third and less than a yard with a minute 54 to go. Just the second Panther penalty on the night. Thanks to Marty Aronoff, our stat man. Thomas Smith got off to a quick start. Pittsburgh fans, significant number of West Virginia fans.
Remember, they got to go at least 25 more yards, it looks like, for me to kick a field goal, which would put the game in overtime. So they don't necessarily have to get a touchdown to win. I mean, they obviously love it, but they could get close enough to kick a field goal.
And Andy Good, a young man who's never kicked this year until this second half, kicked the last field goal after Brad Cooper was blocked before halftime. Clock starts on that whistle. Third and short. Marshall, a designed run, gets the first down at the 37. I know many have been watching NFL all day. Just to remind you, clock stops till chains are set, then we'll resume on the ready-to-play whistle.
This is the old single-wing tee where you use the quarterback as a tailback. It's a simple isolation play, but instead of the tailback running it, the tailback's going to lead the way through to take out the linebacker. And Marshall, of course, is the guy who needs to pick up the first.
Now, if I was West Virginia, I'd be going a little more urgency. It was blown back to play at 140. It's going to be 20 seconds before they get the snap off. Marshall Marshall. Dancing, looking for somebody to make a play downfield. Now taking off to the sideline. Gets out of bounds with a gain of about a yard or so. Here with 71 seconds remaining.
What's the longest field goal Cooper's ever kicked?
Well, Cooper has a 54-yarder earlier this year against East Carolina.
I mean, I would bring back in Cooper in this situation because I know that he's done it before, you know?
Mm-hmm.
54.
Mike Black says that it's interesting. Good kicked a field goal at the end of the blue goal game. 29-yarders, time expired to win it in spring football.
I'd go with Cooper.
Mike, spotter up here, former excellent kicker at Boise State. From the 35, it's second down. Marshall, this is like the whole offense right now. He's in trouble. He gets out of trouble and out of bounds. He's saving these timeouts with a minute and four to go. You're going to have third, and let's see, third about a half dozen. This has to be so hard for a defense to keep defending snap after snap after snap.
Chasing him down. I mean, it's running sideline to sideline. And Mike, you're right. He's kind of taken this game over. He's now at this point saying, "We're not going to lose this game. I'm going to will us to a victory. We're going to get this thing into overtime." One way or another, Marshall feels like he's going to make a play to win this game for West Virginia.
Double reverse, pass back to Marshall maybe. Thrown towards Marshall, it is! Dropped at the goal line! Dwayne Thompson, a guy who's gonna get a shot at quarterback next year, the second to get it. Quarterback by trade, almost hits Marshall.
Like I said, one way or another, Rasheed Marshall is going to have a hand in this and try to win this game. The ball is actually thrown, the adjustment there. The future maybe of Rasheed Marshall as a receiver in the NFL. Watch him come back to this football. A little bit of a push. That would have been a heck of a catch. But I can't believe the third down at six and wild play.
H.B. Blades, the linebacker, great coverage to stay with Marshall. Fourth and six, the Mountaineers to keep their BCS hopes alive when you come back.
This is our house. Everything you have trained for your entire life has prepared you for this moment.
It's us for Steph.
All I want to talk about is how big they are. And then this is the year they knock us off. Well, when they come in here, they got to play our game in our house, and nobody beats us in our house.
The Rose Bowl. New Year's Day, 100,000 fans will pack this place. Impressive number. Allstate has their own impressive number, 1,000,000. That's about how many drivers switched to Allstate last year, enough to fill 10 Rose Bowls. Why? Many of them saved an average of $278 a year. Now that calls for a parade. Championship insurance for less. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
You know, I think I'd marry you again. All these people as witnesses?
Yeah, right. Mom? Dad?
Lisa, will you marry me? Again.
This Christmas, give her a piece of eternity.
Two hometown kids, Tyler Palko from West Allegheny High School. He led a gutsy drive of a dozen plays down the field to put Pittsburgh on top. And now a kid who grew up on Webster Avenue over in the Hill District of Pittsburgh, who used to ride his bike into Old Pitt Stadium to watch the Panthers play. Rasheed Marshall now must come up with the biggest play of his career to keep the Mountaineers alive. Fourth and five, and the game on the line again. Marshall rolls, throws it downfield, incomplete! Somebody get Tyler his helmet. And somebody get the Panthers an orange shirt. They got to start rooting for Syracuse.
They rolled Marshall. They tried a wheel route. They decided to take a chance to Joe Hunter and try to win the game, not just go for the conversion on fourth down.
Remember, they went twice with trick plays to try to win the football game where it could have been two plays to make a first down.
The Mountaineers have two timeouts remaining. If Pittsburgh holds on to win and gets Syracuse to beat Boston College on Saturday on Chestnut Hill, then we'd have a four-way tie atop the Big East. Palko running for a first down. He's very close. He's got it. He's got the first down, and that'll do it.
26 minutes on the stop.
Out at the 44-yard line. Mountaineers take out their first. Our Wrangler players of the game. Wrangler 8 catches 124 yards. Marshall 249 of West Virginia's 358 yards. They are our Wrangler players of the game, as has been our Thanksgiving tradition for the last half dozen years. The dessert on Thanksgiving, our nighttime game, the pecan and the apple pie.
Pecan pie goes to Rasheed Marshall, West Virginia. Great effort, man.
I'm going to give mine to the Pittsburgh defense and Paul Rhodes, yes, the defensive coordinator. Just an unbelievable performance tonight by the Panthers defense in containing Rasheed Marshall and keeping him in his football game.
And the Alamo, the vanilla ice cream that we used to get in Mississippi, they brought us that here. I would give it to Tyler Palko for the job he did tonight. Gutsy, game meaning so much to him. Look at Paul Rhodes.
There he is. He's getting a pop.
This is a Pittsburgh team that went to overtime with Furman, lost to Connecticut, lost on their home field to Nebraska, lost in double overtime up at Syracuse. They still have a game on ESPN2 at South Florida next week. After picking up the first down, there's only one timeout left. That's all they need to do. They don't need to run another play.
They've won 5 of their last 6, a chance to finish it off with 6 of their last 7. And they've returned 10 new starters on offense. That's pretty impressive to be able to turn that thing around by Walt Harris and his team.
Last time out for the Mountaineers. One more snap will get it done. Susie and Scott standing by for SportsCenter. Peyton Manning continues to pace. The Cowboys going back and forth with Drew Henson and Vinny today. We'll talk about Louisville, their quarterback situation. Remember, they play Cincinnati on Saturday. Louisville coming into the Big East next year. Pittsburgh has a chance to represent this league in the BCS.
We had an opportunity to see our old friend Beano Cook here today. Former star at ESPN, looking pretty good. Beano, the former SID in Pittsburgh, and one of the most famous guys ever to work. The father of College Game Day, Beano Cook.
Great to see Beano today. Well, guys, if Pittsburgh wins, and we mentioned the potential of Syracuse beating Boston College Saturday, Paul Peterson.